Dallas or Fort Worth? Designer Dallas or old school cowboy Fort Worth? Who has it better? Everyone's got an opinion. Tonight, a chance to settle it on the field, and a berth in the state semifinals is on the line. Top-seeded Dallas Christian and number 2 seed Fort Worth Christian in the Taps Division II playoffs on Friday Night Football. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to DeSoto's Eagle Stadium, the site tonight for Friday Night Football for the third time this year, in fact. This time, though, Eagles not on the field. It's Fort Worth Christian and Dallas Christian, Julius, two very good private school football teams duking it out for a berth in the state semifinals.
Yeah, Mike, I'm excited to be back in the stadium. Third time's a charm, right? Fort Worth versus Dallas tonight, so it's a big rivalry.
This is a rematch of a game played earlier this season. October 1st, Dallas Christian beat Fort Worth Christian 35-25. And while it was a win for Dallas Christian, Fort Worth Christian and their first year head coach Nate Sanford believes that was really the turning point for their football team. Since they lost that game, they've gone 4-2. They've really started to find themselves.
Yeah, they're on a little bit of a hot streak right now. Didn't start the season off well, like you said, but now the ball's rolling into playoffs, and that's really good for them.
Now they meet with that berth in the state semifinals on the line, and Fort Worth Christian believes that they've got the chops to kind of pull off the upset against a Dallas Christian team that played for a state championship just last year. Dallas Christian, though, is a team with some unfinished business. If you don't know, the way that they finished their 2020 season was about as gut-wrenching as football can provide. Let's take you back to last December in the Taps Division II state championship game, a tie football game in the final minute between Austin Regents and Dallas Christian. Absolutely. Five wide receivers set out of the timeout. Pressure, fires, double coverage, and it's intercepted, and a lot of green grass in front of them. A here for Burkle on the return, inside the 30, cuts back inside the 20. Ben Burkle with the walk-off pick six to win it as time expires. Austin okay. Regents, state champs in Taps Division II. An unbelievable finish.
What a way to finish a game. Holy smokes.
Julius, it doesn't get worse than that. That is as hard a way that you could finish a season. Mike Wheeler, their head coach, said to me, he said, he hasn't stopped thinking about that football game and that play and other things that happened that led up to that play. They've got some unfinished business. This is a team that is very focused on making up for what happened to finish their season last year.
Yeah, they are. Heartbreaking losses call for motivated teams the next season. So both these teams have a lot on the line tonight, especially because it's playoffs, but it's a little different feeling for this game.
Gabe Grubbs, one of the best players for this Dallas Christian team, a player that was a key piece for them last year as well, has taken to tweeting on multiple occasions with the hashtag 2620 mentality. 26-20, the final score of that game against Austin Regents. They are using that as fuel this season. Let's get to our players to watch for tonight. First for Fort Worth Christian, and it is their superstar wide receiver, Jacob Trimble, already as a junior, the all-time leader in receiving yards at Fort Worth Christian.
Yeah, those are some crazy stats right there on his list right now. He's really good off the line, good speed, and if you miss him on the open field, he's going to be gone.
This year, he also has the single-season record now for Fort Worth Christian for receiving yards. Last week in their playoff opener, 5 receptions for 138 yards and 3 touchdowns. Meanwhile, for Dallas Christian, it is Gabe Grubbs, their star safety. He's also a key piece for them offensively, but defensively is where he earns his stripes. This is a kid going to Marshall to play football.
Yeah, he lines up all over the field for them, linebacker, safety, defensive lineman. He's really physical and a great tackler in space.
Not a very outspoken leader, but certainly one of the leaders of this football team, according to his head coach, Mike Wheeler. One of these teams is headed to the state semifinals. Who's got the better Christians, Dallas or Fort Worth? Kickoff is next on Friday Night Football.
We are not here to fit into a mold. We are here to celebrate and learn from the unexpected, diverse, and beautiful gente. The fuerte, the strong, the ones risking it all. Para la familia, para la oportunidad, for the lovers of dance, of food, of music. ¡Que viva! We are here to grow together. We are here to thrive, juntos, celebrating our lives every day. La vida.
Our stories are everything. We tell them to help us understand who we are and where we're going from here. That's why we're sharing even more WFAA original stories, where the seeds of healing are sown by those who have reaped so much pain. Stories where ancient rhythms can speak so much louder than words, and a 50-year march for equality can become a national reality, one bold step at a time. WFAA originals. Story is everything. Weeknights at 10.
Misinformation, fabrication, and falsehoods. Fake news is on the rise, and it's coming from all sides. On WFAA News at 10, we're separating the fiction from the facts with our series, Verify. You ask the question. Our team verifies the answer. We find sources and get explanations. Have something you want verified? Find us online or email verify at WFAA.com. Watch weeknights at 10 on WFAA.
As we welcome you live to Eagle Stadium in DeSoto, WFAA proudly presents Friday Night Football live on the WFAA Digital Network. The second round of the TAPS Division II playoffs as Dallas Christian and Fort Worth Christian look to advance to the state semifinals. Coin toss at midfield right now. Captains from both teams down at the 50-yard line. And momentarily, we'll know who's got the ball first in this one. Julius Lewis, two very good football teams, as you see. The head coach from Dallas Christian, Mike Wheeler, in his 30th year at Dallas Christian. Four state titles to his name, the most recent one in 2008. Meanwhile, for Fort Worth Christian, their head coach, Nate Sanford, his first year at Fort Worth Christian, came over from Alabama Christian. Our officiating crew tonight, Jonathan Vanderhoff, the referee, talking to the captains at midfield. A slow motion coin toss tonight, Julius Lewis. We are ready to get this one started. Looks like Fort Worth Christian won the toss.
A lot of conversation going on.
We need a direct audio feed, yeah. Apparently. So Fort Worth Christian has won the toss. They will defer. So it will be Dallas Christian to get the football to start the football game, which means we get to see their freshman quarterback, Luke Carney. 6'1", 175 as a freshman, Julius Lewis. This kid is very talented for a freshman quarterback, a young man who dabbled briefly with the possibility of going to IMG Academy in Florida. That's the talent level we're talking about with this kid. He's a freshman, so freshmen sometimes make freshman mistakes, but we talk about raw ability. This kid is extremely talented.
He's got a nice arm on him. He can sling the rock around a lot. To be a freshman starting, regardless of his private school or not, to be a freshman starting on a team like this, high-level team, they went to state last year, got to be legit.
Berth in the state semifinals on the line tonight. The Dallas Christian Chargers made it to the state championship game a year ago. We showed you that clip just a moment ago off the top of the broadcast. Lost that game in heartbreaking fashion, and they have very much utilized that finish against Austin Regents as motivation this year to try and get back to the state championship game. It'll be Jackson Beck to kick it away for Fort Worth Christian, the sophomore, and deep to return for Dallas Christian will be Will Nettles, the sophomore, and Tripp Roberts, the senior. Fort Worth Christian lost their first five games of this football season. That fifth loss to Dallas Christian back on October the 1st, 35-25. Since then, though, they've gone 4-2, including 3-1 in district play to earn their way here to the state quarterfinals. And we are underway in DeSoto. Short kick fielded and brought out to the 45-yard line. Nice work by Jaleel Brown, the running back from Dallas Christian. Not a bad person for the Chargers to have the football end up with. And he brings it out to the 46-yard line. It looks like they'll spot it. And it's 1st and 10.
So one thing I like about rematches and in the playoffs, these teams know each other. They know their plays. They know their opponent. So I want to see how each team's going to adjust tonight. See if the Fort Worth Christian get a little bit different outcome than during the season.
First and 10. They will put it right at the 45-yard line, and Jaleel Brown will have the football in his hands once again through the secondary, down the right sideline, inside the 20. Foot race to the pylon, pushed into the end zone. Touchdown, Dallas Christian, on the very first play from scrimmage. I think the Chargers were ready tonight.
Yeah, I think they were ready. That's a perfect way to start the game. Can't script it up any better than that.
Jaleel Brown right through the Fort Worth Christian defense. 55 yards for the touchdown. And it's 6-0, 16 seconds in.
Technically, he got all the yards on that drive.
Indeed, he did. All of the kick return yards and all of the yards from scrimmage on one play. PAT from Jacob Holzel up and through. And it's a 7-0 start from Dallas Christian in a blink.
Wonder if this is nerves from Fort Worth Christian. I knew what happened earlier in the year. At the end of the day, you have that in the back of your mind. You know this team already beat you. So there's a sense that maybe they are better than you. So I wonder if they have that on their minds right now.
And it's interesting because we talked about this off the top. Their head coach, Nate Sanford, said, you know, listen, we fell behind 14-0 in that football game. But he felt from that point forward, for the final three quarters of that game, he said they felt like they outplayed Dallas Christian.
Yeah.
Played them, in fact, statistically, just score-wise, they did outplay them. Won the rest of that football game, I guess, technically by 4 points. It was a 10-point final margin, 35-25. The Dallas Christian won that football game. And they really built on that confidence the rest of the way. You look at their schedule the rest of the way, they hung 67 on Coram Deo. They hung 50 on Grapevine Faith, 62 on McKinney Christian, and that's just their last three games. They really started to turn the offense on, and they turned their season around thanks to that loss to Dallas Christian. But again, here they are spotting Dallas Christian an early lead.
Yeah. Don't want to give a team an early lead, especially like that.
So out comes Holzel to kick it away. Trimble and Anderson deep to return. They'll let it bounce through the end zone. And out comes Trevor Andrews and the Fort Worth Christian Cardinals offense. Andrews, the senior quarterback, a week ago against McKinney Christian, 15-24 for 266 and four touchdowns. And his top target, we talked about him off the top of the broadcast, Jacob Trimble, the junior wide receiver. Already, Julius, with the all-time career receiving yardage record at Fort Worth Christian, with still another season to play.
Yeah, he's going to definitely, whatever he ends up tonight, plus the rest of the playoffs, if they make it that far, and next year, man, it's going to be a tough record to beat going forward.
First and 10 at the 25 for Andrews in shotgun. Four wides to the left, and they will go to Trimble on the first play of the game. Good blocking in front, but a nice job to knife through and make the play by Will Nettles, the sophomore.
From 27-yard line for a gain of two. Brings up second down and eight.
Little unusual formations out of them.
No down and distance information coming through for us right now. We'll keep an eye on that.
Play on the play.
Flag here before the snap. And it will be a false start, courtesy of our referee, Jonathan Vanderhoff. Seven-man crew tonight. For Division II TAPS State Quarterfinals. Second and 13 after the penalty.
A lot of motion for Fort Worth Christian pre-snap right now.
Design QB draw, and Trevor Andrews takes it and gets him back across the original line of scrimmage. Sets up a more manageable here, Julius, third down and seven.
And I kind of like that play design right there. That flash motion, get the back out, gets the linebacker's eyes out of position. A little bit more room for the quarterback to run up the middle.
7-0 our score, thanks to a 55-yard touchdown run from Jaleel Brown on the very first play from scrimmage. And now Fort Worth Christian trying to find an answer. Over the middle, behind him, and a nice catch. Trimble ranging back to make the catch on the ball that was behind him, and it's a first down.
Andrews does a really good job right here. Going through his reads, climbing the pocket, setting his feet, and making a good throw.
Sidearm delivery to get it around the defender, put it on target, and it's a first down. Now a quick throw to the near side. Nice move in space by Carter Marlowe, the senior running back, to make a man miss and a pickup of six.
The If their offense can do this all night, take away the penalties, they can do this 5-6 yards of play, get it out in space to the athletes really quickly, and I feel like they'd be successful tonight.
Second down and four after the pickup. Dallas Christian and Fort Worth Christian on the WFA YouTube channel tonight. Please let us know in the comment feed where you're watching from, who you're tuning in to see tonight as Marlowe takes it around the right edge. He'll have the first down, and they're into Dallas Christian territory for the first time this evening. Comment from Michael Hall. Says, wow, first play score. Jaleel Brown took it 55 yards to the end zone, but credit to Fort Worth Christian, Julius. They've responded here with a nice drive to start off here. Ball tipped at the line of scrimmage and falls harmlessly incomplete. He was looking for Jordan Green, the big 6'5 target over the middle, but it didn't get there.
Yeah, it looks like they had man coverage on this one right here. The defensive lineman got his hands up, knocked the ball down.
Second down and 10 after the knockdown. Andrews, their quarterback, Julius, only 5'9". Makes it a little bit tough to get the ball over those big defensive linemen sometimes. This time he'll roll to the left, pressure in his face. Tries to evade it, and he will not. Taken down deep in the backfield. Nick Barr, the sophomore, with the sack.
That's a good job right there by Nick Barr. Not giving up on his rush right there. I'm from the backside on this one. Got close to a face mask, but good job staying away from it.
And that sets up third down and a mile. They've got to get all the way to the 32-yard line for a first down. Third down and 28. Andrews scanning, looks over the middle, has a man complete, but that'll be well short of the first down. Fort Worth Christian's going to have to punt it away here. They do punt out of their offensive set, so you'll see the offense stay on the field here, but I think it's fairly safe to say, Julius, that they're not going for it here on fourth down and 22. And indeed, Andrews does punt it away up the far sideline, takes a good bounce. That's going to work out quite well for the Cardinals. Downed by Trimble inside the 15, and back comes the Dallas Christian offense. So a good drive for Fort Worth Christian for a moment there, but not able to capitalize on it, and now they've got to give it back to the Chargers here.
Yeah, that sack really hurt him. In that situation, you just want to try to throw it out of bounds. It looked like he tried to make a play. Just got to take your loss on that one, trying not to take a sack. But yeah, like you said, that drive was going somewhere for him. Sacks and penalties kill drives every time.
7-0 Dallas Christian the score. First meeting between these two teams. Chargers jumped out to a 14-0 lead after the first quarter. Very even from that point forward, but a big day for Jaleel Brown in that game. And he gets the carry once again, gets the corner. Jaleel Brown up the near sideline, showing off the speed again. Still on his feet inside the 30-yard line. He made a man miss at the line of scrimmage. And he was off to the races.
It looks like Dallas Christian's game plan tonight is feed Jaleel Brown.
Really just a good, lack of contain there on the outside. You can't let him get outside you like that.
Yeah, corner's got to be a lot more aggressive on that one. Jaleel shouldn't be able to run around you like that, but credit to him.
First and 10 at the 26 now. Give it to Jaleel Brown once again. Why not after the way he started this football game?
Yeah, exactly. Probably got 100 rushing yards already.
The first one was 55 for the touchdown.
The last one was
that 50. One, I believe they were at the 14-yard line, so do the math on that. The 14 to the 26.
Almost 60, right?
I think it is. I think it's 60 on the nose, is it not? 24 and 34.
Oh, it was a sight.
24
major.
And 36, I should say. 60 major. Yards on the nose, so just a casual 115 yards on two carries to start the game for Jaleel Brown. The last two have gone for a total of two as that one loses a couple of yards and it'll be third and eight.
Hopefully after a bit of sprinting for Fort Worth Christian's defense on those two carries by Jaleel Brown, they're warmed up now, they're in the game, and hopefully they can get a defensive stop right here and hold Dallas Christian to a field goal.
That's certainly what Nate Sanford's hoping for. The first-year head coach came over from Alabama Christian. He actually started his coaching career, though, here at Fort Worth Christian way back in the late 90s. Nice throw on the far side. Gabe Grubbs trying to break a tackle, will not. Nice effort on the far side there by Luke Anderson, the junior linebacker, to not let him free at its fourth down.
He almost got out of that one.
Brian Anderson says he's watching from Fort Worth. Says, go Luke Anderson, who just made the play right there. Fourth down and two for Dallas Christian. Have to get right to the 16-yard line, and now a timeout prior to the snap called by Mike Wheeler. Cody Crow says hello from Heber Springs, Arkansas. Appreciate you being with us tonight on the WFAA YouTube channel. Again, please let us know where you're watching from tonight, who you're tuning in to see tonight. If you've got a favorite player on one of these two teams, perhaps a son or a grandson, a nephew, whatever the case may be, perhaps even a member of one of the cheer squads or bands, we'll show you their halftime show as the Cardinal Bells drill team will take the field first for Fort Worth Christian, the Cardinal marching band to follow, and the Dallas Christian varsity and JV cheerleaders will be part of the halftime show as well. We'll bring that to you here in a quarter and a half's time, but in the meantime, Julius, fourth and two here, forthcoming for Dallas Christian. We've seen certainly Jaleel Brown has worked pretty well so far. You imagine some more of that may get dialed up right here.
Yeah, I think that's what everybody in here is thinking tonight. But honestly, I think someone else might get the ball on this play. Just throwing out something.
Fourth down and two. Tighter set here from Dallas Christian. The freshman Carney barks out signals. Now looks back to the near side to offensive coordinator Brian Coghlan. Max Makeda. Cycling down closer to the formation, handoff to Brown, spins off a tackle, he's got the first down. They had him momentarily in the backfield, but he wiggled free, picked up the first down, and sets up first and goal.
Yep, just had to play devil's advocate and say he wasn't getting the ball, so we really a slippery runner. Hard to bring down, too.
All the way down to the 7-yard line, and Jaleel Brown with a tremendous start to this football game. Sets up first and goal for the Chargers. Carney under center now. Brown again with the handoff. Inside the 5 to the 2 is where they'll mark his forward progress stopped.
I think we're closing in on a similar situation what happened in their last game that they played.
The ball carrier stopped at the 2-yard line.
Exactly what Nate Sanford didn't want tonight was to fall into a similar 14-0 hole, but they're going to have to do some work here, second and goal from the 2, to avoid exactly that. Straight eye behind Carney. Brown behind Grubbs. He'll get the handoff, and he's in. Walks into the end zone. And Dallas Christian with touchdowns on each of their first two possessions tonight.
And Jaleel Brown's going to be a workhorse for them tonight. Looks around and says it's too easy.
It has been so far.
So now if you're Fort Worth Christian, you just got to regroup. Do what you did last time. Take away the sack, and they had a solid drive.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if nothing else, Nate Sanford certainly has the ability to say, well, we've been in exactly this position before, back on October 1st when these two teams played in the regular season. It was 14-0 in favor of Dallas Christian after the first quarter. From that point forward, Fort Worth Christian played very well, made it a football game the rest of the way, 35-25 the final score. But here they are once again in a 14-0 hole as the extra point from Holzel is up and through, and Jaleel Brown with a tremendous start to this football game. A pair of touchdowns already well over 100 rushing yards. And a 14-0 lead for his football team.
It was crazy stats for the first quarter.
7 carries, 135 yards, and 2 touchdowns officially so far. Not bad for, 6 minutes and 32 seconds worth of work.
It's almost like 20 yards a carry.
19.3 yards per carry, yep. Not that this thing is ever actually possible. But just for fun, 135 yards in, we'll say, half a quarter to be safe. He's on pace for over 1,000 rushing yards tonight.
Keep feeding him.
Not expecting to see that actually play out, but just to illustrate how good a start it's been for Jaleel Brown, the senior running back. So back comes Trevor Andrews and company. Now in a hole, Julius, and needing to do more of what they did on that first drive, but with more consistency to be able to finish the possession.
Yeah, I feel like there was no sense of urgency. They were just calling plays, getting the ball out. Just I don't want to say speed it up a little bit, but put your foot on the gas.
They do feel like when they are a hurry-up offense, when they can put some pressure on the defense, is when they are at their best. We'll see if they can execute that here on their second possession of the evening. Andrews looking far sideline to the offensive coordinator Brady Gunn, and now a timeout called by Fort Worth Christian prior to the snap.
Somebody just ran on the field late, right before that timeout. I don't know if he was a late substitution or just forgot he was supposed to be playing, but he ran out late.
I guess some miscommunication on the sideline prior to the first play of this possession, because that's certainly the last time where you'd expect to need to call a timeout, Julius, is on the opening play of a series.
Yeah. It was a really slow start for Fort Worth Christian. Offensively, defensively, maybe coaching-wise as well. Got to pick it up right here in the last half of this first quarter.
Out of the timeout, first and 10. Andrews will have three wide receivers to the top of the formation. Now a motion man is Anderson out that way. He'll get the swing pass. Nice work on the outside defensively. Who was it who came through and made that play? I think it was Max Makeda. Watch this again as Makeda shrugs off a block. I don't know if you'll see. Yeah, right here. Goes right through a blocker and makes the tackle.
It's a really good play right there, because if he wasn't able to get off that block, Fort Worth Christian had numbers. Mm-hmm. Nobody went out there when the back motioned out. A little miscommunication from the linebackers.
Just an individual effort there from Makeda, and that saves him. Nice strike on the outside. First down for Fort Worth Christian.
See, I think that Fort Worth Christian needs to do this. Go down the field with their passing game. Use the route concepts they have. Let Trevor Andrews find the open man.
Jordan Green, the big 6'5 target on the receiving end, and they move the sticks. First and 10 at the 35. Andrews. Deep ball up the far sideline, just a bit too far. Overshot Jacob Trimble.
Yeah, exactly. That's what they need to do, though. Take their shots. Already down 14. Yeah, you can nickel and dime it down the field a little bit, but still, don't forget to take your shots.
You can see it just watching the way that this game has unfolded already, that Fort Worth Christian has the athletes to play here. It's just, I feel like they kind of need that one play that kind of gives them a little bit of confidence and kind of livens them up a little bit. Because like you said, it's been a little bit of a slow start for them, but they have the players out there. Andrews, pressure in his face once again, and down he goes. Swallowed up at the 23-yard line.
Just needed a little bit more time. He had a guy open. I don't know if the back was supposed to be there in protection or not, but another sack. That's how their last drive went south.
Jackson Ivy coming off the edge, got the sack. But it was the entire cavalry in the backfield, and it sets up third down and 21. A little razzle-dazzle here on the reverse for Trimble. Trimble across the 30. He won't be able to get the first down, but that does earn back a big chunk of the yards. Coming out of the pile with the football there was Trip Roberts, but the officials say that Trimble was down.
He was able to get one more block out here on the edge. He might have been able to turn that up for a little bit more.
Again, Fort Worth Christian does punt with their quarterback, so unclear whether they're going for it here or not. The way he's backing up a little bit further certainly indicates he's about to punt this football away. And he does up the far sideline. Makeda back there to give chase, but he'll let it bounce inside the 30. And back comes the Dallas Christian offense. So Now, Fort Worth Christian's defense absolutely, Julius, needs to make a stop here because otherwise this game can get tilted sideways real fast.
Yeah, their offense wasn't able to create some life for them, so their defense is going to have to do it themselves. Like you said, it can get out of hand really quick if they don't get a stop right here. So being down 21 in the first quarter is not fun.
Jeff Kirk says he's curious to see if Fort Worth Christian is willing to kick the ball to Trip Roberts, says he's a special teams threat for Dallas Christian. Jeff Kirk watching from Rockwall tonight. We appreciate it, Jeff. Raul Garcia says, shout out to the cameraman. Raul Garcia is one of our cameramen. I'm not sure if that's actually Raul or not. Ball on the deck. Pressure. Ball still out. Fort Worth Christian with the recovery and a walk-in touchdown for the Cardinals. Luke Anderson on the scoop and score, and is that ever the play that Fort Worth Christian needed?
That's what I meant by the defense going to have to bring their own life.
He took a big hit after the ball was on the deck. It was a low snap for Luke Carney, the freshman quarterback. And I think it was Gus Sanchez that laid the hit on him to keep that ball free. Anderson, the junior, the leader of this defense with the scoop and score, and all of a sudden, Fort Worth Christian with a little bit of life.
We're just talking about how they needed to stop before this game got out of hand for them, and just like that, they flipped the script.
In a blink. The fumble recovery returned for a touchdown for Luke Anderson, and it's 14-7.
I also think that play was doomed from the start, whatever was going to happen. Fort Worth Christian was in the backfield as soon as that ball was snapped.
20 yards officially on the fumble recovery and the return for Luke Anderson. But no, I mean, it's a huge play just from on all levels. This game was looking like it was about to tilt real hard against Fort Worth Christian, and that brings everything back to life.
It does. Now their defense has some life. Hopefully that gives their offense some life, that sideline some life.
Caitlin Hilliard says, let's go five. I'm not sure if that's for Fort Worth Christian or Dallas Christian, either KJ Hilliard or Grady Gann. Oh, of course. It must be KJ Hilliard if it's Caitlin Hilliard saying that. Tiffany Solis Sims says, let's go, kick. Dallas Christian.
They tried the onside.
Caught me by surprise, even. I'm sitting here looking at the YouTube. Jackson Ivy with the recovery for Dallas Christian.
The ball was kicked a little bit wider, had a higher bounce on that.
Yeah.
I think they could have got it.
I like Worth Christian going for the surprise on sides, and Nate Sanford caught me napping looking at YouTube comments.
I like the risk, though.
I mean, especially when, I mean, shoot, they kicked it deep, and Dallas Christian returned it to the 45-yard line.
Yep.
So you gave up 2 yards in field position? Why not give it a shot? First and 10 here for Dallas Christian from the 47-yard line. Jaleel Brown on the carry, hopping around in the backfield, flag on the play.
Now Fort Worth Christian is playing assignment football.
It's just all of a sudden they're awake. It almost looked like they finally came to life with that one play.
A couple drives ago, Jaleel Brown was able to cut that ball outside, but now you have guys playing outside contain, making them bounce back inside.
Daryl Snyder says, shout out to the Chargers. Number 74, KJ Johnson, all the way from Virginia, says, Uncle Daryl watching tonight. Uncle Daryl, we appreciate you being with us.
Now we got Dallas Christian getting penalties.
Holding penalty bounces them back into a first and 20 now inside their own 40-yard line. So that great field position now tilted a little bit as well. Motion man across the formation is Grubbs. Carney looking near side, swings it out this way for Jaleel Brown and chased down immediately. And once again, it is Luke Anderson making the play.
Honestly, between the first 5.5 minutes of this game and the second 5.5 minutes game of this game, this defense looks completely different.
It's like night and day. a defense that, I mean, just for example, the play where Jaleel Brown on the second possession was able to get to break outside contain and come up the near sideline, it looked like it was going to be an easy night for him. And then you watch that play we just saw happen. I don't know how to explain the difference in what we've seen, but it is stark.
Now they're rallying to the ball too. Because the coach is had to go on the sideline and get a little butt chewing going on.
It worked. And it's going to be third down now and 14. Carney, the freshman, on the year, 19 touchdown passes, just four interceptions. This is a talented young man. He's got four wide receivers in this set, three to the right. Play action, looking over the middle, too tall, but it ends up right in the hands of a waiting receiver, and into the end zone goes Trip Roberts. 56 yards on the touchdown pass, and I can tell you with an awful lot of confidence, that was not the intended receiver on this play.
Yeah, sometimes it just lands in your lap like that. Just happened to be in the right, the perfect place at the right time.
You know, you get some breaks sometimes playing football, but that's about as good a break as you could ask for right there. Trip Roberts in the right place at the right time.
I bet you they'll tell us later it was scripted.
Yeah, I'm sure. Max Makeda was the receiver underneath that I'm fairly confident Luke Carney was gunning for on that play. But what a play by Trip Roberts. Undeterred by all the traffic between him and the football, and it falls right into his lap. And it's 21-7 Dallas Christian.
He's going to be a fun game tonight.
I think we're going to see some points, if nothing else. 28 of them here in the first 10 minutes and 31 seconds of the football game.
Great to see what Fort Worth Christian's offense is going to do coming out of. They've been on the sideline for a while now.
They certainly need to develop some consistency. I mean, we've seen them move the football. We've seen them do some good things, but it's been in fits and spurts. They've struggled with penalties. They've struggled with the two sacks that have basically ended their possessions. Just clean up a couple things, and I think they can move the football with some good success, but it just hasn't all come together just yet.
Yeah, I like how they're trying to take their shots, but they need to add a little bit more in protection when they do it. Both times they tried to go deep, the offensive line wasn't able to hold up in protection.
Cameron in the YouTube comments says, watching DC from Alabama. Blake Crocker says he's watching from here at the stadium.
I wonder if our friend from Moscow is here, or Poland.
No, you're right, it's Moscow. We've had, and pardon me, the name is escaping me, Elisee Rodriguez. Yeah. It finally just popped back into my head. Has been watching all year from Moscow. I haven't seen him in the comments yet. We'll see. Touchback there off the kickoff from Holzel. And back comes this Fort Worth Christian offense. Jaden Williams in the comments says, straight luck. Honestly, I struggle to disagree with you. I mean, that was a very fortunate play for Dallas Christian, but sometimes you need that. First and 10, handoff off the fake on the screen on the far side, but nothing doing in the interior there for Carter Marlowe.
Yeah, what I'm noticing is these Dallas Christian linebackers are not adjusting to these running back motions at all. The running back will go out to the flats. Nobody will go with him.
What goes into a decision like that? I mean, is that a conscious decision perhaps from the Dallas Christian coaching staff that they don't respect the motion, or they don't believe the motion as they come option near side and run to the sideline? Was Trevor Andrews. Nice defensive play in the middle.
I don't think it's a lack of respect. I think it might be a little bit of game planning, missed assignments maybe.
I don't mean to say necessarily a lack of respect of the individual player, but just they don't buy that's going to be an actual piece of the play. Maybe.
It's like a bluff. They're calling their bluff.
Yeah,
definitely.
Gain of a yard on the option play there for Andrews. Third down and 9. He'll go to the air, or at least he'll attempt to. Pressured and taken down again. Another sack for the Dallas Christian defensive front, and it's fourth down.
Yeah, this D-line is just relentless right now, fighting off blocks. Just making life for Trevor Andrews terrible right now.
Greg Saldivar with the sack, the big junior, and it is fourth down and 16. 21-7, Dallas Christian with the lead and looking to get the football back after this on Friday Night Football.
We are not here to fit into a mold. We are here to celebrate and learn from the unexpected, diverse, and beautiful gente. The fuerte, the strong, the ones risking it all. Para la familia. Para la oportunidad. For the lovers of dance, of food, of music. ¡Que viva! We are here to grow together. We are here to thrive. Juntos. Celebrating our lives. Every day. La vida.
Our stories are everything. We tell them to help us understand who we are and where we're going from here. That's why we're sharing even more WFAA original stories, where the seeds of healing are sown by those who have reaped so much pain. Stories where ancient rhythms can speak so much louder than words, and a 50-year march for equality.
As we welcome you back here on Friday Night Football, and they do punt it away on fourth down and 16. Makeda back to return the punt, receives it at the 50-yard line, spins off a would-be tackler into Fort Worth Christian territory and all the way down to the 41-yard line. A nice return there from Max Makeda from Dallas Christian, and back comes the Chargers offense. Now, Julius, it almost feels like looking for a knockout blow.
Yeah, definitely looking for a knockout blow. During the break, I called a pick six. I'm just going to let everybody know. I was going to keep it to myself, but I'm calling a pick six. But, yeah, definitely looking for that knockout punch early.
Carrie D. says, let's go D.C., watching her nephew, number five. K.J. Hilliard, number five for Dallas Christian. Kylel Brown says, big brother and family watching. Jaleel Brown from Virginia says, go DC.
Oh, there he goes, running up. Yeah, that's twice tonight he ran on the field late.
Another timeout here called by Dallas Christian, so they've now used, I believe that's their second used timeout.
So earlier, when Jaleel Brown ran on the field, Fort Worth Christian actually called a timeout.
That's what it is. Okay.
Yeah. This time, Dallas Christian had to call a timeout because
13 seconds in here to this second quarter, a 21-7 lead in favor of Dallas Christian, and it has been Jaleel Brown so far, Julius Lewis, that has done the majority of the damage for the Chargers. A 55-yard touchdown run on the opening play of the football game, and then he was a key piece in their second touchdown drive as well, capping it off with a 2-yard touchdown run. What is it that Dallas Christian is doing to be so effective on the ground, at least through that first quarter?
I think they're just playing a lot more physical. Ground game's all about physicality. Definitely when you have a special athlete who can make people miss in space, that adds to it, but a lot more physical.
Hand off on the jet motion, but taken down in the backfield is Trip Roberts. Well pursued there by Fort Worth Christian.
But now you see Fort Worth Christian starting to play more physical. There's five guys in the backfield right now. Playing faster, more physical. And honestly, besides the first 5.5 minutes, and that, I guess we call it a lucky catch right there, they've been playing a lot better.
They have turned things around from a very shaky start defensively. Nice play there by Julian Sanchez, knifing through to start the process, and then Luke Anderson finished the tackle. This time, Jaleel Brown swallowed up in the backfield.
There's an all-out blitz right there.
Alex Harrelson this time leading the charge. He's really the leader of that defensive front for Fort Worth Christian. The 6'5", 211-pound junior in the backfield. Back-to-back tackles for loss, and it's third down and a mile.
This is exactly what you wanted if you're Fort Worth Christian's defense. Just gave up a touchdown. Your offense didn't do anything on their possession. Exactly what you want right here.
Have to get to the 20-yard line for a first down. Carney, the freshman, rolling back. Scanning, pressure in his face, and taken down finally. Luke Anderson knifing across to get him. And it's another loss of yardage there for Dallas Christian, and they'll have to punt.
Yeah, that was a coverage sack right there for forward Christian. Had everybody locked up right now. You got people walking on the field. Thought the play was over. Yeah, that was a great job right there by forward Christian's defense.
It really is just night and day, this Fort Worth Christian defense, from the opening 5-6 minutes of the football game, and then from that point forward. Two entirely different units. First punt of the football game for Dallas Christian. Line drive punt. Bounces inside the 20. It's going to take a good bounce inside the 5. You can't do it any better than that. Downed at the 2-yard line. Grubbs down there to down it. And hey, Fort Worth Christian, you're down 21-7. It's been a tough sledding, tough start for you through the first quarter and 3 minutes or so. Now go start at your 2-yard line.
Yep. Couldn't write it up any better than this. 98-yard drive. see if we get a 10-minute drive out of this.
I'm sure Nate Sanford wouldn't mind that. Bright sunshine in the comments says, let's go Chargers. Bill B. says, I hope Christians win. You'll be a happy man tonight, Bill B. Fort Worth Christian and Dallas Christian.
See if we take a shot right here. Oh, that's why I couldn't be an OC. I see man coverage on the outside. Even at my 2-yard line, we're going. We're taking a shot.
Hand off up the middle. Luke Anderson on the carry and gains maybe a yard or two. Call it a gain of a yard and 2nd and 9. Just trying to give Trevor Andrews and company a little bit of breathing room. We have seen them take some sacks here in the early going, so that's got to be in the back of Brady Gunn's mind, the offensive coordinator. Hand off once again for Anderson, and again, nowhere to go. Driven back this time. Jackson Ivey on the tackle.
And if you're right, if you're Dallas Christian and you're in this position, you can just pin your ears back and just rush.
Officially, that'll go down as no gain. 3rd down and 9 here.
Yeah, I'm taking my shot right now. It looks like, yeah, cover one.
Andrews looking right side, has a man, complete, 1st down, breaking a tackle is Trimble, and all of a sudden with some breathing room is this Fort Worth Christian offense.
Yeah, he's such a vertical threat. The DB plays so far off, and he's able to shut it down right there at the sticks.
Now they'll come near side. Jordan Green on the receiving end. Swarmed and gang tackled there at the 25-yard line.
That looks like this one might be coming back. This is a good play design right here. If he was able to get one of these blocks right here, probably could have got a couple more yards out of it.
There was a flag out at the 30-yard line. They bring it back to the 25 and drop it there, and it will be a hold against Fort Worth Christian. Brady Gunn, the offensive coordinator for Fort Worth Christian, previously their head coach here for a while, from 07 to 18. And it was funny, I was talking with their head coach, Nate Sanford, about Coach Gunn earlier this week, and he said, it's unbelievable. He doesn't have a play sheet. He just does it all in his head. He's got the entire offense in his head. He said, I don't know how he does it. Andrews rolling out, able to escape, fires downfield, and a nice play by Trimble to come back and play defensive back there and prevent an interception.
Yeah, that's one of those easy picks right there. You just don't really go up for it. Will Nettles, you got to high point that one and go reach out for it. Can't let it come to you.
Jacob Trimble bailing his quarterback out right there. Second and long here. They've got to get to the 31-yard line. 2nd down and 17, and a tighter formation now here for Andrews.
Probably some crossing routes if they do pass. Somebody fell.
Looking far side, floated it too far. looking for Carter Marlowe on the sideline.
I think there was some miscommunication. I think Carter Marlowe was supposed to be the only person on that side of the field.
Instead, Jordan Green in the vicinity as well, and it sets up third down and 17.
You take Jordan Green out of that picture, there's nothing but green grass out there.
Nobody followed Marlowe out there for Dallas Christian. But the pass off target, and it's third and long. Three wide receivers bunched to the left side of the formation. Andrews over the middle. What a catch. Skying to make the grab as Jordan Green breaks a tackle and a first down. What a play by the junior.
I for sure thought that was going to be a pick or a pass breakup. Great concentration right there. Great ball, too.
I mean, Jaleel Brown made a heck of a play on the football. And somehow Green able to still hang on to it. And a first down and a big play there for Fort Worth Christian. Andrews looking near side, incomplete. Looked like he and Gus Sanchez were on a different page there, and now Sanchez is down after he got undercut after that ball sailed by.
Yeah, that turf is not your friend, especially being in the air and just laying on your back or falling on your back like that. Does not feel good.
The way he got undercut and was just parallel to the ground and hit hard. You'll see it again right here. Took a hard hit to his back right side, right shoulder and right side of his back. But he's up on his feet now.
Yeah, he's going to be feeling that one tomorrow.
Nate Sanford, their head coach, you get a good look at there. Their first year head coach coming over from Alabama Christian. Had a successful run there over the course of five seasons. And now back to Texas. He spent a little while down in a good chunk of time down in the Houston Woodland Spring area. Coached there for about 15 years, he says. Raised his daughters there, raised his family there. Went to Alabama for a couple of years, now back to Fort Worth Christian where it all began for him. Trying to take his team to the state semifinals tonight. Quick swing pass to the outside, nothing doing for Carter Marlowe.
I think Fort Worth Christian needs to come back to the exact same play, get the safety to motion out there with the running back because they're not moving the linebackers out, and then come back and hit this backside vertical.
Well, if you've got Brady Gunn's cell number.
Yeah, right. Just go down to the box down there. Hey, I got to play it for you guys.
Third down and a dozen here, and they go five wides. Andrews in shotgun. Three to his left, two to his right. Pressure in his face, quick throw, far side, complete Trimble, and he'll have the first down.
Yeah, they've been saving themselves on third down tonight. Two big third down conversions on this drive.
And after it took him a little while to get Jacob Trimble going, now he is. Able to wrestle his way for a couple extra yards through the grasp of Will Nettles and move the chains.
Now they're speeding it up a little bit.
Quarterback draw, and Dallas Christian not fooled by that in the slightest. Jackson Berry on the tackle.
Yeah, usually when you get empty, you're going to get something quick, or you get a QB draw.
Loss of two on the play for Trevor Andrews. Andrews was hurt early on the season. We mentioned the Fort Worth Christian lost their first five games of the year. Part of that was the injury to Andrews. They were starting a freshman for an extended stretch there. Nice defensive play to break up that ball at the end of the reception. Max Makeda knocking it loose of the grasp of Jordan Green, and it'll be third and long.
Yeah, that was a good job coming in there with a physical tackle to break the ball up.
But Hogan Nelson was the starting quarterback for Fort Worth Christian for the first several games of the year. Just a freshman, talented kid, certainly has a bright future for him, but it's hard to be a freshman starting quarterback in high school football. And the Cardinals struggled to an 0-5 start, but as Andrews has gotten back into the swing of things, Fort Worth Christian has started to play real well, 4-2 over the course of their last six games. Flag on the play here as they went for the reverse, nothing doing there for Trimble.
Big call right here because if it's against Fort Worth Christian, or excuse me, Dallas Christian, might be a first down.
Side judge threw the flag. It'll be a hold against Fort Worth Christian. They will decline the penalty, and it will be fourth down. And depending on where they spot the ball here, about 10, I believe.
You know, as an offense, you don't want to be one-dimensional. But I feel like Fort Worth Christian had a lot of success in the passing game on this drive, and they went away from it a couple plays, and they went backwards.
And the drive stalls, and another punt here from the quarterback, Andrews. Dangerous play there by Makeda, but it may pay off for him as he goes back to field it across the 45, cuts back across midfield. Makeda inside the 40. Makeda with a convoy inside the 15. Touchdown, Max Makeda.
No flags, too, so it's going to stay.
He bobbled it at first. No matter. To the house goes Max Makeda, the senior, and Dallas Christian with a 27-7 lead.
Good job not to get out of bounds right there. Great vision. Good job using his blocks. Getting in the end zone for six.
82 yards on the punt return for a touchdown from Max Makeda. And with 5:27 to play here in the second quarter, Dallas Christian, an extra point here from Jacob Hosel away from a 28-7 lead. It's up and through.
Just when you think Fort Worth Christian is starting to come alive a little bit, they end up putting the ball away, and Dallas Christian takes advantage of it.
And this is something, in talking with Nate Sanford, their head coach, he said they specifically punt out of this offensive formation. One, because they feel like their quarterback, Trevor Andrews, has got a pretty good leg. He's done a nice job tonight kind of trying to pin Dallas Christian back. But he said we also do it in an effort to kind of at least limit, if not eliminate, the potential for returns. But the one problem is if you do offer up the opportunity, as Max Makeda was able to go grasp for himself, you don't have a traditional coverage unit on the field. Yeah. Tackling is not exactly the strong suit of the Fort Worth Christian offensive line, I have to imagine.
So when you do that, you have to, you run the risk of that protection, like you were saying. You don't really get the proper net down there to cover all the lanes. So tough one.
And Makeda goes 82 for the touchdown on the punt return. 28-7 Dallas Christian. Line drive kickoff, and they'll let it go through the end zone once again. So now we've said it a few times tonight, Julius, that Fort Worth Christian has shown the ability to move the football, but that they haven't been able to finish drives, and that has been the story all night long. If they're going to make this a football game, that has to change in very short order.
Yeah, like now. Get some points going into halftime. Get some type of – just get something going into halftime going. Defensive stop, big play, passing game, explosive play, just get something going.
Dallas Christian did have the football to start this game, so it will be Fort Worth Christian football to start the second half. Luke Anderson with the carry there for a couple. If you're Nate Sanford, that has to be the thought process, though, right now. Drive down the football field, you certainly hope, go get a touchdown, 28-14. Get the ball back to start the second half, go get another score, and make this a football game. But they need the offense to start finding some consistency here. Andrews is going to take off and run for it, tries to spin through the tackle of Trip Roberts, but can't. Does get out to the 34-yard line and sets up third down and a yard.
That's a good tackle right there by Trip Roberts. Got a guy coming at you full steam ahead. Hit you with a spin move and you're still able to wrap him, tackle him down. That's a textbook right there.
That was one thing Mike Wheeler, the head coach from Dallas Christian, did say earlier this week, is he was concerned a little bit about Andrew's ability to get outside the pocket and run. He's going to try and run for it again here. Grubbs was in the backfield. He started the process, and that'll go down as no gain. And it's going to be fourth down and a yard.
Just take that one outside just a little bit. He had the edge there.
Grubbs was just in the backfield so fast, though, it was hard for him to even have a second to process. So fourth down and a yard. Do they punt it away here, or do they go for it?
They go for it.
They will. Hand off. Anderson gets outside. He's got the first down, and he's into the secondary across midfield. Luke Anderson up the sideline. Much more than just a first down. Fort Worth Christian with a big play into Dallas Christian territory.
Yeah, I think Fort Worth Christian just needs to scratch the quarterback runs from their offensive game plan tonight. Just put it in your running back's hand if you're going to run the ball.
Luke Anderson with a big carry there. The 6'1", 194-pound junior sets up first and 10 at the 40-yard stripe. Andrews looking right. Trimble caught. Reaches the ball forward. Beg your pardon, that's Gus Sanchez on the receiving end. 9, not 7. And a first down for Fort Worth Christian. I kind of feel like only reach the ball out like that if it's at the end zone, not at the 30-yard line. Yeah. That's dangerously close to being a fumble.
Maybe I'll give him a fourth down and you need it.
Okay, fourth down. I can get there.
But that was very dangerous.
Quick throw right side. That's complete in the hands of Trimble. Give him about 9.5 on the reception and very close to first down yardage again.
One thing I've noticed about Andrews and his receivers, they have a really good relationship. The ball's out by the time they're out their breaks.
The timing is really crisp.
Yes.
Second down and a yard.
And that is why I think they should keep passing the ball.
This is the deepest penetration we've seen Fort Worth Christian's offense get all day. Anderson moves right to left behind Andrews. Scanning, comes near side four. Luke Anderson makes a man miss. That'll be enough for the first down, not much more, but it moves the chains inside the red zone.
They're getting really creative in their passing game. Lots of creativity, lots of misdirection. This is what I think they need to do right now going forward the rest of the game.
Fort Worth Christian trying to get back in the football game with this drive here. Andrews looking end zone for Trimble. Incomplete out there in single coverage with Max Makeda.
He had the right idea on that one. But if he would have looked to the other side of the field, he had somebody wide open in the end zone. I think that was that on the bottom of the screen? Jordan Green, wide open in the end zone.
Instead, second down and 10. They've got to get to the 8-yard line for a first down. 2:37 to play here, first half. Again, it will be Fort Worth Christian ball to start the second half, so a score here could be quite important for the Cardinals. Play action, strike over the middle, into the end zone, touchdown, Jacob Trimble. Right on the money from Trevor Andrews, and the Cardinals strike back.
That's the type of play I need right there. That gets the linebackers out the window, gets the safety's eyes in the wrong spot. Just opens up the middle of the field for you. It's a really good play call.
18 yards on a dot from Andrews to Trimble. And Fort Worth Christian finds the end zone for the first time offensively tonight. And did they ever need that drive? That ball's blocked. So it'll stay 28-13.
Let's see how this comes into play later in the game.
It could be a very important point.
Now they get a stop right here in their defense right before halftime. The momentum might start to sway towards Fort Worth Christian a little bit.
Certainly an important drive there for the Cardinals. Trevor Andrews leads them down the football field. Don't forget the big fourth down run, though, from Luke Anderson that kept this drive alive. But then Andrews hooking up with Trimble, hooking up with Gus Sanchez a couple times on the possession, and they finish it off with the 18-yard Andrews to Trimble touchdown pass. And it's 28-13. 2:32 to play here in the second quarter. Mike Leslie and Julius Lewis here with you on the WFAA YouTube channel. We do appreciate you being with us tonight. Please, on the YouTube feed, drop us a comment. Let us know where you're watching from tonight, who you're tuning in to see this evening. And please, click that like button in the bottom right-hand corner. Click the subscribe button. As we have brought you a high school football broadcast here on the WFAA YouTube channel all season long. We'll be back again next year for sure. Still TBD whether we will have any further broadcast this year. We're certainly working in that direction. We'll have that information for you as soon as we have it.
Yeah, Let's get it done, Suits. Get it done.
Kickoff return from Trip Roberts. Man, you're gonna get me in trouble. Back comes the Dallas Christian offense with a 28-13 lead. And you said it a moment ago. Now Fort Worth Christian, the defense that we've seen make some strides over the course of this evening, they need to see more of that. I mean, the last two touchdowns from Dallas Christian have been certainly the punt return isn't on the defense. And I would argue that the 56-yard touchdown pass from Carney to Roberts really wasn't truly on the defense, if you will. It was kind of a fluky play. Since those first two drives, they really haven't given up much. We'll see what they can do here. Pressure, and that is an incomplete pass. Correctly called by the officials. Now a flag.
That's what I was
thinking. Okay, they're going to call intentional grounding. Carney, the freshman, had Luke Anderson in his lap in a heartbeat.
Yeah, but I agree with everything you just said. It wasn't actually on the defense the last 14 points. The defense definitely played better from the middle of the first quarter on to now. But
And it will be intentional grounding on Carney. Another look at it here is, again, just in a heartbeat, right in the face of Luke Carney was Luke Anderson, the junior. I guess I shouldn't be remotely surprised that in a game between Fort Worth Christian and Dallas Christian, there would be two young men named Luke involved in the same play. That's on brand.
Very on brand.
Penalty sets up second down and 19, as intentional grounding is a loss of down penalty as well. And off for Jaleel Brown up the middle. Crashed into and finally driven back.
Somebody's hurt down there.
Jackson Brownlow finished it off, but there is a player down for Dallas Christian. I think it might be Gabe Grubbs, their star senior wide receiver and defensive back, and that is exactly who it is.
I think he's in a lot of pain, too.
See if we can see what happens here. He got undercut.
That's not good right there.
Oh, no. The kind of thing you just hate to see. That's one of the best players on this Dallas Christian football team on his way to Marshall. A key player for them offensively and defensively. He was a key piece for them a year ago when they made the run to the state championship game. Arguably even more important this year as a senior. Good to see him up under his own power walking off. That's very encouraging because it's hard not to go certain places mentally when you see a play like that.
Especially like that. It's getting cut from inside while you're running, while that leg's planted in the ground.
No, that's very encouraging to see him walk off under his own power. Dallas Christian, a team that's already had one young man suffer an ACL tear earlier this year, Heath Flanagan, a young man who actually played on that ACL tear for a couple of games. Mike Wheeler said it was one of the more incredible things he's seen, the passion that Heath Flanagan showed for being on the football field, one of the captains of this team. After all of that, third down and long. Carney up the middle, and it's intercepted. Up top for the pick for Fort Worth Christian is Gus Sanchez, and he's inside the 30-yard line. And all of a sudden, this game has shifted.
I thought that was going to be my pick six I called a couple drives ago. But yeah, you're right. This game has definitely shifted a lot.
Number nine picking off number nine. Gus Sanchez with the interception on Luke Carney, the freshman, returns it back inside the 30-yard line, and out comes the Cardinals offense and Fort Worth Christian with life here late in the second quarter.
Yeah, lots of life right here. Hopefully they can get at least 3 points out of this drive to really just carry a lot of momentum from that last scoring drive and hopefully momentum into this drive into halftime.
We mentioned a good sign seeing Gabe Grubbs walk off the field under his own power. He's already back on the football field. That's a really good sign for Dallas Christian. Quick throw right side. Trimble on the receiving end. Give him 8 on the play.
The timing between these guys is incredible. No wonder why he's broken so many school records already.
Trimble, the all-time receiving yardage leader at Fort Worth as of last week. And he's only a junior. Second down and a deuce. Play action. Pressure. And down he goes once again.
There we go. That's exactly what Dallas Christian needed right there.
It's Tyler Williams, the senior, with the sack. All the way back to the 30-yard line and sets up third down and, I beg your pardon, they're going to spot it at the 28-yard line. It'll be third and nine and a timeout called by Dallas Christian.
This game's got a little bit interesting last 17 minutes.
It has indeed. Beg your pardon, Fort Worth Christian with the timeout. Now both teams with one timeout remaining. But now Fort Worth Christian, the way that they have battled back in this football game, they were down 14-0 in a blink. And frankly, looked outmatched in the first 6.5 minutes of this football game. What the Dallas Christian offense was able to do to the Fort Worth Christian defense in the first 6.5 minutes of the football game, it looked like it was going to be a long night for Fort Worth Christian. Their defense has responded in a big way. The other 14 points on the board have not been against the Fort Worth Christian defense for all intents and purposes. And the Fort Worth Christian offense has finally started to move the football with some consistency. Much more of a game than I think we expected to see right now with a 1:10 on the clock in the second quarter, and they're trying to make it even closer. Shot near side. What a catch made on the sideline. That was inbounds for Jordan Green. Look at this one again.
Perfect placement, perfect catch right there.
Man, that is a special catch from Jordan Green, the junior, and he needed every bit of his 6'5" frame to go up and get that one. First and 10 at the 12-yard line. Quick snap here for Andrews. Looking far side, single coverage, looking to the end zone, incomplete. He was going for Green once again. I beg your pardon, Gus Sanchez, the intended target.
Good coverage by Nettles right there. Didn't really panic. Really matched the route with the receiver really well. Played the ball in the air. Couldn't write it up any better.
Again, Cardinals will have the ball to start the second half, so if they can find some points here, all of a sudden, it really starts to tighten up a little bit. Second down and 10. They've got to get to the 2-yard line for a first down. Of course, they want all dozen of those yards they've got left to get. Motion man is Trimble across the formation. Now cycles back. They'll fake the look to him. Now over the middle for Green. He makes the catch, but he's tied up. A little bit of an extra hit there. I don't think this was dirty in the slightest. I think it was just confusion as to whether or not the play was over as Grubbs came through to take him down. They marked him down, forward progress having been stopped at the 7-yard line, and it'll be third down and 5, and now there's a player down here for Dallas Christian.
Yeah, I was watching the replay while you were talking. He might have got stepped on or rolled up on that early part of that play during the rush. It's going to be right here in the middle of the screen when he gets put down, so.
It's Tyler Williams, the defensive end, who made the sack just a few plays ago for Dallas Christian. Now being tended to there at the 15-yard line.
Like I said earlier, this is a physical game. Early on in the game was Dallas Christian showing a lot of their physicality now. You've seen Fort Worth Christian show what they have to offer. Now it's just back and forth battle between both the teams.
As they get Tyler Williams back to his feet here. Walking off under his own power, but certainly a pretty substantial limp there. We'll see whether or not the senior defensive end is able to get back on the football field tonight for the Chargers. That's one of the things about these private school teams, especially the smaller levels than Division I. There's not a lot of depth. A lot of these guys are going both ways. Looks like it's Cameron Hilliard, I believe, on the far sideline, on the far side of the defensive line now for Dallas Christian. Trimble in motion, third down and 5. They'll fake it to him, looking over the middle once again. End zone, touchdown. Jordan Green once again on the receiving end. They ran that play a couple of times in the recent sequence. This time it pops for a touchdown, and Fort Worth Christian is right back in this ballgame.
Yeah, right back in it. They used a lot of what's been working for them on this drive. Misdirection. Shifting the back out one way, passing the ball back the opposite way. It's exactly how they're going to win this game tonight if they want to have Are they going for two right here?
It certainly looks like they're going to leave Trevor Andrews in the offense on the football field and go for two and try and get back on pace and get to 21.
Is that what the analytics say do right now?
I'm not sure that they do. Timeout called by Dallas Christian prior to this two-point conversion attempt. 35 seconds left here in the half. And Fort Worth Christian with another touchdown pass here for Andrews. This time hooking up with Jordan Green.
Timeout charge for the Chargers with their final timeout the first half.
Yeah, if you would have told me at the end, if you would have told me the first 5 minutes of this game, going into halftime, that Fort Worth Christian would have a chance to be down one touchdown, I would have probably thought you were watching a different game.
I mean, it's the reality of what we saw. The opening 5-6 minutes of this football game, Fort Worth Christian looked overmatched. They have not looked overmatched the remainder of this first half that we've seen. I'm not sure what it is about these two teams that Fort Worth Christian feels that they need to fall into a 14-0 hole like they did earlier this season and then come to life, but they've done it now in both meetings.
Ooh, what is this? Okay.
Show me a drop kick.
Show me a corner route to the top of the screen. Corner route to the top
look
of the
at
screen.
This.
Top of the
Wide
screen.
Wide open in the end zone, and two more for Fort Worth Christian. It's Bryce Bradley, the H-back on the receiving end, and it's a one-touchdown game, Fort Worth Christian and Dallas Christian.
So, they created a lot of space. Oh, there was a corner route. Okay, I guess I can give myself that one. It was more of an arrow route, but they created a lot of space right there at the top of the field just for that route concept.
And it's 28-21. With 35 seconds to play here in the opening half, and I say it again, Fort Worth Christian ball at halftime. What a different game this is from just a few moments ago. It was 28-7, 2 minutes worth of clock time ago.
Crazy.
This game has completely turned on its ear.
And now both sides of the ball for Fort Worth Christian have life. So...
back-to-back touchdown drives for Fort Worth Christian. This one started by the interception that Gus Sanchez made. And the Cardinals are right back in this football game.
Second half's going to be really interesting.
Kick popped up far side, fielded at the 28-yard line, and fair caught there. Smart play by Franklin Michael as the coverage team was bearing down on him. And with 34 seconds left here in this first half, back comes the Dallas Christian offense.
34 seconds, no timeouts. Say just run. Either run a run play, go into halftime with it, or try to get at least 10 yards, get out of bounds real quick. Take a shot.
So Andrews with two touchdown passes on the day, an 18-yarder and an 8-yarder. And right back in this football game is Fort Worth Christian. Let's see what Luke Carney, the freshman, can do with the final 34 seconds. Dallas Christian without any timeouts remaining. They hand it off to Jaleel Brown up the middle. He'll push the pile for 4 yards. And that may well be the final play of the opening half. Clock down under 20. No need for Dallas Christian to snap it. And as Fort Worth Christian fires up their fans on the far side, Dallas Christian content to head to halftime with a 28-21 lead. Fort Worth Christian with a pair of touchdowns in the final 2 minutes and 32 seconds of this opening half. And we've got ourselves a football game, folks. 7-point lead for Dallas Christian at halftime. The halftime show forthcoming here on Friday Night Football. The Cardinal Bells drill team, the Cardinal marching band from Fort Worth Christian, and the Dallas Christian varsity and JV cheerleaders all coming your way next at halftime on Friday Night Football.
Are not not here to fit into a mold. We are here to celebrate and learn from the unexpected, diverse, and beautiful gente. The fuerte, the strong, the ones risking it all. Para la familia, para la oportunidad. For the lovers of dance, of food, of music. ¡Que viva! We are here to grow together. We are here to thrive, juntos, celebrating our lives every day. La vida.
Our stories are everything. We tell them to help us understand who we are and where we're going from here. That's why we're sharing even more WFAA original stories, where the seeds of healing are sown by those who have reaped so much pain. Stories where ancient rhythms can speak so much louder than words, and a 50-year march for equality can become a national reality. One bold step at a time. WFAA originals. Story is everything. Weeknights at 10.
As we welcome you back here on Friday Night Football, it is halftime here in DeSoto, 28-21, the lead for Dallas Christian. And their senior cheerleaders, their varsity and JV cheerleaders, under the direction of their head coach, April Roberts, first up here on halftime.
Tonight, I'd like to introduce to you the junior varsity cheerleaders. Brindley Dean. Bracey Goods. Avery King. Paxton Nix. All-star jumper and all-star stunt group, Caroline Punch. All-star jumper finalist, Morgan Schismacher. Taylor Steele. Reagan Tyson and Jenna Rawson. How about a big round of applause for those junior varsity cheerleaders? And now, for Dallas Christian varsity cheerleaders, sophomore and all-star jumper award winner, Brinley Kirk. Junior all-star jumper, Emma Grace Burke. Junior, Alisa Harvey. Senior, all-star jumper and all-star tumbler, Mia Wally. Senior, co-captain, all-star jumper and all-American, Lexi Briggs. Senior, co-captain, all-star jumper and all-American, Eliza Matenich. Let's give a big round of applause for your Dallas Christian cheerleaders, directors, Ms. April Roberts, Chelsea Buckham, Laura Limerick, and Tara Kirk.
All right, next up here at halftime on Friday Night Football, the Cardinal Bells Drill Team from Fort Worth Christian. That'll be followed by the Cardinal Marching Band. We hope you enjoy the show.
Tonight, the Cardinal Bells are performing a high kick routine to neon lights. The Bells are led onto the field tonight by Social Officer Katie Moore, Sophomore Officer Claire Stone, Senior Officer Maggie Quinn, Senior Officer Emma Stade, and Captain Victoria Hicks. Ladies and gentlemen, your Cardinal Bell Drill Team.
Gentlemen, your Cardinal Bell Drill Team.
And onto the field comes the Fort Worth Christian Cardinal Marching Band, our final piece of the halftime show. We hope you enjoy their performance.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the field your Fort Worth Christian Cardinal Marching Band. The Cardinal Marching Band is being led onto the field tonight by our 2021 Cardinal Vanguard, featuring Nicole Stroud, Elijah Sullivan, Jonathan Clark, Joshua Martinez, Mr. Caden Croson, Isaac Robert, and drum major Brady Stroud. Tonight, the band will be performing their full 2021 show, Star Trek Into Darkness. And now presenting drum major Brady Stroud and your Cardinal Marching Band. Drum major, the field is yours. We'll be right back. gentlemen, your Cardinal Marching Band. The band is under the direction of the great Ryan Nicolo.
Our thanks once again to the Cardinal Bells Drill Team, the Cardinal Marching Band from Fort Worth Christian, and the Dallas Christian Varsity and JV Cheerleaders for our halftime show tonight on Friday Night Football. About 8 minutes to go until second half action. We'll step aside here for a moment. We'll return on Friday Night Football.
We are not here to fit into a mold. We are here to celebrate and learn from the unexpected, diverse, and beautiful gente. The fuerte, the strong, the ones risking it all. Para la familia. Para la oportunidad. For the lovers of dance, of food, of music. ¡Que viva! We are here to grow together. We are here to thrive, juntos, celebrating our lives every day. La vida.
Our stories are everything. We tell them to help us understand who we are and where we're going from here. That's why we're sharing even more WFAA original stories, where the seeds of healing are sown by those who have reaped so much pain. Stories where ancient rhythms can speak so much louder than words, and a 50-year march for equality can become a national reality. One bold step at a time. WFAA originals. Story is everything. Weeknights at 10.
Misinformation, fabrication, and falsehoods. Fake news is on the rise, and it's coming from all sides. On WFAA News at 10, we're separating the fiction from the facts with our series, Verify. You ask the question. Our team verifies the answer. We find sources and get explanations. Have something you want verified? Find us online or email verify at WFAA.com. Watch weeknights at 10 on WFAA.
The news can bring you down. That's why on Daybreak, we balance that with I Am Up.
Up on all the latest around town, sure, but also celebrity gossip, sports, and...
Well, you've got to be up on the weather before you head out the door. And don't forget the...
Traffic. We're up in all the hot spots. Plus, we are giving you plenty of reasons to smile.
Because we are up with Daybreak.
What about you?
When severe weather's in the forecast, a process begins, and it's a process that includes not only the weather team, it includes the entire news department. Where is it going to happen? How severe is it going to be? What type of bad weather are we expecting? Once we have that in place, then everyone's assigned a job. The story that we tell is a story that is going to allow you to absorb it, for you to understand it, and for you to be able to take that information and keep you and your family safe.
As we welcome you back on Friday Night Football inside the broadcast booth for the first time tonight, Mike Leslie and Julius Lewis back here with you. 28-21, our halftime score in favor of Dallas Christian. Julius, very different first quarter and second quarter. First quarter was basically all Dallas Christian, and even a couple minutes into the second quarter was all Dallas Christian. They led this game 28-7, but two quick touchdowns from Fort Worth Christian in the final 2.5 minutes, and all of a sudden we've got ourselves a football game.
Yeah, like you said, I thought Dallas Christian was going to run away with it early. Fort Worth Christian able to battle back, fight strong, gain some momentum, and they're coming out of halftime with a lot of juice.
Let's take a look at your halftime stats here through the first 24 minutes of play. A substantial edge in first downs. That's certainly indicative of how much Dallas Christian moved the ball with big plays in that first half. A 55-yard touchdown run from Jaleel Brown on the very first play from scrimmage. Another long touchdown pass later in the game from Luke Kearney to Trip Roberts. So the first down total, not really indicative of how well Dallas Christian moved the football. But Fort Worth Christian making this a much more even halftime stat sheet than probably what we expected couple minutes into the second quarter.
Yeah, definitely. And those rush yards for Dallas Christian really came on those first two drives. Ever since the first two drives, 30 yards really and 60 yards passing yards. So I feel like Fort Worth Christian is really winning. They won that second quarter for sure outright.
That bottom right category, two turnovers for Dallas Christian, also very key in that first half. The interception late in the first half by Fort Worth Christian's Gus Sanchez, a big play that led to that late touchdown pass that Gus Sanchez was on the receiving end for to help get Fort Worth Christian back in this football game. And now they get the football to start here in this second half. Very, very quickly, Nate Sanford's team turned this game upside down.
Definitely turned it upside down, and I'm excited to see what both teams have to offer. Is Dallas Christian going to fight back? Because now I feel like they're the underdog for the rest of the game, and is Fort Worth Christian going to build on the momentum they had?
That's interesting. I don't know that I thought you would go quite to that extent, that Dallas Christian's the underdog the rest of the way. They do have the seven-point lead, but certainly Fort Worth Christian has turned things around, has had the better of play over the course of the final 5-6 minutes of that second quarter, maybe a little bit longer than that. We'll see if they can continue that out of halftime and get back further into this football game, perhaps even tie it up early on in this third quarter. We'll step aside one more time here at halftime on Friday Night Football, but when we return, the second half kickoff. Fort Worth Christian with the football, looking to tie the football game when we return on Friday Night Football.
We are not here to fit into a mold. We are here to celebrate and learn from the unexpected, diverse, and beautiful gente. The fuerte, the strong, the ones risking it all. Para la familia. Para la oportunidad. For the lovers of dance, of food, of music. ¡Que viva! We are here to grow together. We are here to thrive. Juntos. Celebrating our lives. Every day. La vida.
Our stories are everything. We tell them to help us understand who we are and where we're going from here. That's why we're sharing even more WFAA original stories, where the seeds of healing are sown by those who have reaped so much pain. Stories where ancient rhythms can speak so much louder than words, and a 50-year march for equality can become a national reality, one bold step at a time. WFAA originals. Story is everything. Weeknights at 10.
Misinformation, fabrication, and falsehoods. Fake news is on the rise, and it's coming from all sides. On WFAA News at 10, we're separating the fiction from the facts with our series, Verify. You ask the question. Our team verifies the answer. We find sources and get explanations. Have something you want verified? Find us online or email verify at WFAA.com. Watch weeknights at 10 on WFAA.
The news can bring you down. That's why on Daybreak, we balance that with I Am Up.
Up on all the latest around town, sure, but also celebrity gossip, sports, and...
Well, you've got to be up on the weather before you head out the door. And don't forget the...
Traffic. We're up in all the hot spots. Plus, we are giving you plenty of reasons to smile.
Because we are up with Daybreak.
What about you?
When severe weather's in the forecast, a process begins, and it's a process that includes not only the weather team, it includes the entire news department. Where is it going to happen? How severe is it going to be? What type of bad weather are we expecting? Once we have that in place, then everyone's assigned a job. The story that we tell is a story that is going to allow you to absorb it, for you to understand it.
Back on Friday Night Football, just in time for kickoff here in the second half, and it's another touchback here for Dallas. And out comes Trevor Andrews and company once again. Fort Worth Christian Julius back in this football game. Two Trevor Andrews touchdown passes, one to Jacob Trimble, one to Jordan Green. And it's 28-21 as we start off this second half, so we'll see if Andrews and company can continue the good vibes that they've been able to kind of build there late in the second quarter.
Yeah, good vibes only for them, hopefully, for the second half. But, yeah, definitely want to build off what they did, especially with their offense. Looks like they're coming out with too many men on the field already. Okay, not enough men on the field already.
One more runs on at the last moment there, Bryce Bradley. just in time for the snap. As twice now, we've seen them be a little bit unprepared for the very first play of a series, and an ugly start there for Fort Worth Christian on all fronts. A low ball there from Andrews, and a loss of yardage on the throw to Jacob Trimble.
Yeah, I don't think they didn't really come out ready. Wrong personnel's out there. Bad throw, missed block.
Sets up second down and 15 from their own 20-yard line. Four wide receivers in a stack to the left side of the formation. Gus Sanchez, the lone wide receiver at the bottom of the formation. Looking that way, into double coverage, but he's behind him, and he runs underneath it inside the 40-yard line. What a catch by Jordan Green up the near sideline. First down, Fort Worth Christian at the 29 in Dallas Christian territory.
Trevor Andrews stood in that pocket and took a shot. Dropped a perfect ball right there to midfield. It was a good job right there by Jordan Green running underneath that one.
The 6'5 junior has had a really nice night and makes a big play to open up the second half in style here for the Cardinals. First and 10 at the 29-yard line. Andrews with the handoff here for Luke Anderson up the middle and give him four. Through that opening half, Trevor Andrews, 17 of 26, 147 yards and two touchdowns. For Dallas Christian, Jaleel Brown, of course, leading the way, 11 carries, 147 and two touchdowns. But that early pace of 135 yards in the first 6 minutes and change certainly slowed the rest of the first half. Anderson with a couple more here, and it's third down and short.
It was a good job, though, by Fort Worth Christian. Coming out with a negative play, they'll be able to get a huge chunk of yards on the next play.
Put themselves down and four here.
Yeah, put themselves in scoring position.
Motion man, QB draw. Andrews right up the middle, inside the 15, inside the 10. Spinning his way down to the 7-yard line. Trevor Andrews with the most successful quarterback draw we've seen today from Fort Worth Christian, and it's first and goal.
Okay, maybe I was wrong about them having to pocket that play. but there they go again, using the misdirection.
They're going to go to it once again. Andrews inside the 5, takes a big hit at the 4-yard line, and they'll stop his forward progress at the 3. This game was 28-7 after a Max Makeda punt returned for a touchdown, 82 yards, and Dallas Christian was in firm control of this football game. Fort Worth Christian looking to tie it here. Anderson breaks a tackle in the backfield, got to the 1, but no further. It'll be third down and goal.
Good job right there by Luke Anderson. Initially stopped in the backfield, was able to get 3 or 4 yards out of that one.
Grubbs had him by the ankle, but Anderson was able to rip it free. But Grubbs' effort allowed the rest of the defense to rally and not allow Anderson to get into the end zone.
I think you give it to him again.
Third and goal from the 1. Play action. Andrews going to try and keep it himself. Lowers his shoulder. And he's in. Touchdown, Fort Worth Christian. What a comeback for the Cardinals.
Tough physical running right here. Stopped in the backfield and was able to just fall forward.
And did you see that? Jackson Berry went for the strip and ended up with a towel instead of the football.
Yeah, from up here, I thought he actually grabbed the ball initially.
I think he did get his hands on the football. Just credit to Andrews. He held firm on it too tightly. And all the way back has come Fort Worth Christian, and it's 28-all.
This is why I said Dallas Christian was the underdog going in the second half.
Can we get one more look at the touchdown? Watch this again as Andrews goes in, and watch 7 in black get his hands on the football and try and rip it out. Andrews holds tight to the football, and all that Jackson Berry's got to show for it is the white towel.
Just threw in the towel, if you really think about it. But it's like a little magic trick. You reach for the ball and you pull out a towel.
Man, what a comeback from Fort Worth Christian. Down 28-7 in this football game. and they have tied it up at 28 apiece.
Now we get to see how Dallas Christian gets to respond.
Kick popped up down the right sideline, and Dallas Christian smartly lets it go out of bounds. That'll be a penalty against Fort Worth Christian, and good field position here for Dallas Christian.
So we got another flag.
There was a player down for Fort Worth Christian at the 45-yard line.
I missed what happened there. A lot of discussion going on right now.
Player still down for Fort Worth Christian. Tough to get a look at the number as he's surrounded by the training staff from Fort Worth Christian. But the official is still sorting things out. Of course, the procedural penalty on Fort Worth Christian is rather obvious, but there was another flag that flew late around where Travis Fletcher, the senior from Fort Worth Christian, went down. So obviously the kick out of bounds on Fort Worth Christian. Five-yard penalty from the spot where it went out of bounds, then a dead ball personal foul against Dallas Christian. I didn't catch the number, but of course a 15-yard penalty. So instead of being first and 10 for Dallas Christian at what would have been the 35, ball went out of bounds at the 35 yards from there to the 35, and then instead walk it back to the 20. So big difference in field position here for the Chargers offense, as now all of a sudden, for the first time in a while, Dallas Christian's offense takes the football field back in a dogfight again.
Yeah, it has been a while. Last time they touched the field was that interception, or
yeah,
come back. Okay, wow.
Well, I mean, there was the one play right before the end of the half, but I don't think even Mike Wheeler would consider that a bona fide possession for his offense. The interception that led to the Andrews to Jordan Green 8-yard touchdown run that made it 28-21 is the last time Dallas Christian's offense was on the football field for an actual possession. A 28-minute halftime since then, and two Fort Worth Christian touchdowns since then.
If you really think about it, their offense hasn't even been in the end zone since the end of the first quarter.
1:29 left in the first quarter. The 56-yard touchdown pass from Luke Carney to Tripp Roberts that was admittedly a fortunate play.
I think we're going to get a re-kick, actually.
It looks like Fort Worth Christian's going to elect to take the 15-yard penalty and re-kick.
I think. What's going
I wonder on? If they're going to try and kick onside here.
So I wonder if Dallas Christian, instead of getting the ball, decided to re-kick.
This is very interesting because I'm not sure exactly who would have the choice here because there were penalties on both teams. It's not a circumstance where they are offsetting penalties.
Correct.
Because one of the penalties was during the play, the other was a dead ball penalty. So both penalties, as you saw the officials walk it off, were applied. Now they're going to have to apply them again, I suppose, which I believe is going to lead to a kickoff from the 50-yard line. As you watch the official walk it back to the 35, then turn around and walk it 15 yards back in the other direction. Okay. I give them credit. They are thorough. They're doing their due diligence here, and the kickoff will come from midfield. But I'm not certain as to who had that choice there. As to why, I think it's Dallas Christian that gets the choice because the penalty was in the play.
Yeah.
But I wonder if you're Nate Sanford, you say, all right, we're going to kick it onside here. They will not. They'll kick it deep, and Dallas Christian will field that from right in their own end zone, and that was a poor decision here, or perhaps they're going to try and prove me wrong here. For a second, I thought he may have been able to develop a head of steam and really make something of that for Will Nettles. ultimately he would have been smarter to leave it in the end zone and take the ball at the 25 with a touchback. But he made a decent return out of it, out to the 19. And finally, after all of that, back comes the Dallas Christian offense. So I think it's a one-yard difference in field position from what it would have been if they had taken the initial result, because it would have been at the 20-yard line.
There's some coaching going on out there.
They're thinking this stuff through.
Some analytics.
Carney on play action. Up the middle, wide open. Making a man miss across the 45-yard line, and what a good play to start the series for Dallas Christian. It's Jackson Berry on the receiving end, and a big gainer into Fort Worth Christian territory.
This one's set up like a tight end pop pass. A lot of misdirection on here too. You got guys running out to the sideline, the middle of the field just opened right up.
38 yards from Luke Carney to Jackson Berry, and it's first and 10 at the 43 in Cardinal territory. Now a little misdirection here, and it's Gabe Grubbs with a lot of running room. Grubbs across the 35, inside the 30, spun down, and another first down for Dallas Christian.
Looks like this Dallas Christian offense is firing on all cylinders right now. Got a good block right there from Jackson Berry to seal the edge.
Honestly, what it feels like to me right now is Dallas Christian's playing angry.
Yeah.
I think they feel like this game was 28-7. They had it in the bag, and they've let Fort Worth Christian back into this football game, and they're trying to right that wrong on this drive. First and 10 at the 26-yard line. Jaleel Brown on the carry, running the ladder to the outside, close to first down yardage. Looks like it's right on the line, and they will say is another first down for Dallas Christian. So three plays, three first downs for the Chargers, and they're into the red zone.
I also think Fort Worth Christian's defense has a problem with starting.
Mm.
Starting the halves, or starting the game, starting the halves. Takes them a while to get going.
They could stand to get started here as they've allowed Dallas Christian to drive down inside the red zone here. First and 10, Jaleel Brown to the outside. Brown to the pylon. Touchdown, Dallas Christian.
Touchdown, Chargers.
Jaleel Brown with his third touchdown run of the day.
That's a good jump cut right there. Just shows off his speed to get to the end zone.
The tie game did not last long. I don't think they had second down on that series, did they?
I don't think they did either.
Jaleel Brown, 16 yards on the touchdown run. Brings out Holzel for the extra point. And it's up and through, and it's 35-28.
Christian,
yeah, have a day, Jaleel Brown.
Yeah, three tuds. No, he's probably pretty upset that he didn't get to touch that end zone in the second quarter, but he's right back on track.
14 for a buck 85 and three touchdowns.
Is he still on pace for that 1080?
Not exactly. There was a moment there midway through the first quarter where he was literally on pace for over 1,000 rushing yards today. Slowed down just a hair since then. Still probably on pace for about 250, which is a pretty salty day. So it was the Carney pass to Berry for, 38 yards.
Yep.
The Gabe Grubbs rush for 20 yards.
Yep.
Jaleel Brown for 11, Jaleel Brown for 11, Jaleel Brown for 16. And a 35-28 lead for Dallas Christian.
A drive for the first downs.
Fort Worth Christian scored with 8:43 left in the third quarter to tie the game at 28. A buck 28 later. Dallas Christian back in front.
And that was after a kickoff debacle when we didn't know who was getting the ball and where.
Seriously, that took a minute. Dallas Christian just said, have some. So back comes Trevor Andrews and company. First and 10 from their own 25. Up the middle for Anderson.
I think they give him a yard. Face mask on that one.
Take another look at it here, see if we can spot what you're talking about. Oh, yeah. Maybe shoulder pad, yeah. Maybe.
From that look right there, initially it looked like he grabbed the face mask, but then that. Well, there we go, here we go.
Andrew's going to keep it himself. Nice job to get to the outside, and he's first down and then some. Bangs off another tackle and out of bounds across the 40 to the 43-yard line. What a run from the 5'9 senior quarterback, showing the ability to stay on his feet.
Yeah, that's some tough running right there. Not even using his guys as blockers, using them as shields. He's bouncing outside.
Jaleel Brown came in and laid a hit but didn't wrap, and Andrews bounced off of it. Now Marlowe with his first carry in a little while loses a yard.
There's Gabe Grubbs again doing what he does, playing in the backfield. Glad to see him back out there, because earlier in this game I thought it wasn't looking good for him.
When he got undercut on that play, it was hard not to go to a possible ACL injury, and he popped right back up, walked off under his own power, and was on the field three plays later. Quick throw to the outside, complete, close to midfield. And makes third down a bit more manageable as they pick up six there.
Trevor Andrews throws a really good ball. There's a lot of his balls in the only places where his receiver can catch them.
Grady Gann with his first reception of the day and sets up third and five. They've got to get to the 47-yard line in Dallas Christian territory to move the sticks. Andrews looking far side, ball's too low. Incomplete, looking for Gus Sanchez, and it's fourth down.
Yes, that's the commentator jinx. Just said it like, yeah.
Yeah, we'll blame that on you.
I think you have to go for it here.
It certainly appears that that's the consideration. Again, they do punt out of their offense, so we'll see whether Trevor Andrews stays close to the line of scrimmage or not. It looks like they're going for it here on fourth and five. Andrews to the air, looking far side, and miscommunication once again here between Andrews and Gus Sanchez, and it falls harmlessly incomplete, and it's a turnover on downs.
I want to know what this sideline conversation is right now.
It looked like Andrews was expecting maybe a whip route where he was going to peel back around and head to the sideline. Sanchez continued on his in-breaking route. And the turnover on downs gives it back to Dallas Christian. Jaleel Brown with the handoff. Stiff arms his way off a one tackle and turns the corner and picks up six on the first play of the series.
Yeah, once he gets towards that edge to turn that corner, he's a really hard guy to bring down.
Jackson Brownlow had him singled up, but that's a tough tackle to make in space. Mike Leslie and Julius Lewis here with you on the WFAA YouTube channel. Again, please click the like button, click the subscribe button, and let us know in the comment feed where you're watching from tonight, who you're tuning in to see this evening. If you've got a favorite player on one of these two teams, let us know. Jaleel Brown with the carry up the middle. Jump cut in the hole once again, and he's got the first down. Down across the 35 to the 34, and another first down for the Chargers.
Yeah, I definitely agree with you when I see what I see right now. Dallas Christian playing really angry right now. O-line's blocking very physical right now. Jaleel Brown running very physical right now. I think they're trying to turn the tide of this game for them.
Dallas Christian led this football game 28-7 midway through that second quarter. Let Fort Worth Christian come all the way back to tie the football game at 28. But Jaleel Brown has taken over the football game since that 28-28 score. Now a flag here, a couple of flags. Referee's throwing his hat on the ground for all of the extracurriculars happening there behind the play.
Jonathan Vanderhoff, our referee tonight, tossed his flag, then took his white hat off and tossed it on the ground as there were a couple of players in the trenches tangled up.
Yeah, he brought the notebook out, so somebody's number got written down for unsportsmanlike.
Maybe a couple of somebody's. Morgan Woodley in the comments says, go Chargers. John Mosley says, KJ and Cam says, hashtag grind squad. Jamal Marshall says, my boy's working. He says he's a proud alum. Officials still sorting this out here. Unsportsmanlike against Fort Worth Christian. Unsportsmanlike against Dallas Christian. Offsetting penalties. I believe after all of that, they'll just take the result of the play.
Yep.
He didn't signal whether they would replay the down. There was a first down carry there for Jaleel Brown. The action did happen during the play, so I wonder if they're going to replay the down and if that Jaleel Brown run is going to come off the board here. Mike Wheeler getting an explanation, and that's he's kind of pointing and saying, wait a second, we just carried the ball all the way down inside the 20-yard line. But I think, especially based on where they have the ball placed right now back at the 33-yard line, what Jonathan Vanderhoff, our referee right now, is explaining to Wheeler is that because that penalty from both players happened during the flow of the play, it was not a dead ball penalty. Did Mike Wheeler convince him otherwise? I'm not sure.
Well,
now Nate Sanford's going to want an explanation here on the far sideline.
I feel like if they leave it here, where they're moving the ball right now, then it should have been a dead ball penalty. But he didn't call it.
Oh, you know what? He did signal dead ball, okay. Although it didn't seem that the play... It certainly seemed to me that the play was happening still when the extracurriculars happened that drew the flags.
Okay, I missed the dead ball call then, so yeah.
He did. He did signal dead ball. I'm sorry. No, he didn't. No, he did not signal dead ball. He just signaled unsportsmanlike. Huh. Nate Sanford still talking it through with the officials there you see at the 28-yard line. I don't know if we can read lips from this far away, but... As Clay Marshall, our director right behind me, just said, you may not want to. It's a fair point. After all of that, it is going to be first and 10 for Dallas Christian at the 17-yard line.
Or is it?
We've already seen him move the football once. I don't think they're going to move it again.
I think they should just put it in between...
Just split the difference.
Put it between the 17 and the 32.
Finally, a signal that we're ready for play once again. First and 10, Dallas Christian at the 17-yard line. Hand off for Brown. Jump cut in the backfield once again. Trying to get to the outside. Couldn't break contain. And Jackson Brown, though, there to take him down in the backfield.
That's exactly how you need your corners to play when you have a running back bouncing the ball outside like that. You don't want to be too aggressive and lose contain, but you also don't want to sit too far back and let the running back get the edge on you.
Jay Marshall says he's watching from Searcy, Arkansas. Gel Mero. Apologize if I'm mispronouncing that. Says go DC. Says go Josh. Joseph Watson says go Jaleel. Keep pushing. We've seen a lot of Jaleel Brown tonight, and he's played very well for Dallas Christian. Three touchdowns already and looking for more. Second down and 14, they'll go to the air. Carney, pressure in his face, gets it off, tipped, nearly intercepted and falls harmlessly incomplete.
I think he just showed a little bit of why he's still a freshman. No, not why he's still a freshman. Showed a little bit of that freshman in him.
Mm-hmm. Dangerous pass there that nearly gave the ball away. Bryson Alexander, the corner from Fort Worth Christian, frustrated that he didn't get his hands on that. This is a Fort Worth Christian defense that has 10 interceptions in their last two games coming into tonight. They had another one earlier that set up their third touchdown of the evening, and they nearly had another one right there.
I don't know if you noticed, but Gabe Grubbs is kind of little gimpy out there.
He does look like he's kind of laboring a little bit, yeah. He went down earlier, got hit on his knee, was able to get back up. He's been back on the football field, but you certainly hope he's going to be okay long term. Third and 14, Carney looking end zone. Just a bit too far for Gabe Grubbs, and incomplete, and it's fourth down and long.
Yeah, I like that play design right there. Number 8, Max Makeda, was able to clear out all that space up there, and Gabe Grubbs nearly had him one right there.
He really does look like he's laboring, though. He's struggling out there. So they're going to bring out Jacob Hosel here, the senior kicker. They're going to try a 38-yard field goal from the right hash to extend the lead to 10.
They're going to block right here, maybe? Oh, they're not even going to rush, are they? Oh.
Flags fly.
Oh,
they're
going to...
Grubbs with nowhere to go, but they're going to get another take at this. Fort Worth Christian trying to argue against the penalty. I don't think it's going to work.
Honestly, if you want to have a offsides penalty, I guess it's going to be when they call a fake.
It was offside against Fort Worth. I honestly wonder, was it indeed a called fake?
Or he saw the offside.
Or did he just see the offside and think, well, one, hey, you're not going to get the kickoff probably.
Free play, yeah.
But two, maybe try and take advantage of the free play, yeah. Instead, the 5-yard penalty after they took Grubbs down in the backfield, and they'll try this once again, this time from 33 yards out.
Yeah, I'd go for the fake again. Why not? Just do it.
That snap was wide, and now Grubbs is going to try and have to make something of it. Spins his way, but he won't pick up the first down. The field goal attempt goes south off the bad snap, and Fort Worth Christian gets the stop.
Ooh, just a little bit too wide, like you said. And I thought he had a chance to get it right there.
I'll say this, if you're Mike Wheeler, there's nobody you'd rather have the football in the hands of than Gabe Grubbs in that kind of situation, trying to make a play. But not enough running room, and back comes the Fort Worth Christian offense, still in a 7-point football game. A huge, huge sequence there as the Cardinals defense stands strong and keeps this a one-score game. 3:05 to play, third quarter. First and 10 from their own 13-yard line. Three wides to the near side here for Andrews. Over the middle, tipped and intercepted. Picked off by Max Makeda. It was Barry who got his hands on it. Makeda got underneath it, and Dallas Christian answers right back with a huge defensive play.
Yeah, immediately. I don't think if he wouldn't have got his hands up right here and tipped this ball, I think Jacob Trimble would have been running for the races.
Jackson Barry gets his hands on it. And Max Makeda, a pair of seniors, making a big defensive play. And back comes this Chargers offense with first and 10 in the red zone. Carney under center, straight eye. Jaleel Brown, ball's on the deck. Carney scrambles on top of it.
It's getting a little bit sloppy out here.
Yes, it has in the last 2 minutes or so. It's been a little dicey on both sides. Loss of a couple of yards. It'll be second down and a dozen. Seven-point game, late third quarter. Carney in shotgun, running the option. Going to keep it himself. Cuts upfield and picks up about 5.
That play could have been a lot worse for Fort Worth Christian. They didn't have anybody on the outside to play the pitch right there.
If Carney had seen that possibility, Jaleel Brown's probably walking into the end zone.
Yeah.
Instead, third down and 7 here. We've got to get inside the 9-yard line for a first down. A tight bunch of receivers just to the right side of the offensive line, 3 of them, and then 1 to the near side. That's K.J. Hilliard. A little misdirection here, but played very well and chased down from behind by Luke Anderson. If Luke Anderson doesn't make that play, it may be a touchdown. Instead, what a play by the senior linebacker.
Yeah, like you said, that he might have saved a touchdown. That would have been a touchdown-saving tackle right there. Now we can...
It just looked, the misdirection that they had working there and the blocks that they had, it looked like they had the edge sealed. It was, hey, can K.J. Hilliard make his block on the outside? And if so, he may be the end zone. Instead, once again, out comes Jacob Holzel for a field goal attempt, this time from 33 once again, right in the middle. Snap is good. Hold it down. It's blocked.
That's the block I called.
Diving through for the block is Jacob Trimble, the junior wide receiver, making a play in special teams.
Remember I called the block earlier?
Yes, you did.
They never got a chance to kick it, so I think that carries over.
Look at Jacob Trimble, the full extension. That is sensational. What a sequence we have seen here in the last couple of minutes of this third quarter, all in this little quadrant of the field.
Yep.
A lot has happened to change this football game and swing momentum back and forth. Back comes Trevor Andrews in the Fort Worth Christian offense, still somehow in a seven-point game. 50 seconds to play here in quarter number three, and it's first and 10 from the 36. Andrews stepping up, fires near side, complete in the hands of Grady Gann. And a pickup of 7 on the first play of the series.
All night, their timing's been perfect.
This has turned into a heck of a fun football game, man.
Yes.
Officially give them 8 on the first play of the series. Second down and 2 forthcoming. Anderson the back, they fake the play action to him, rolling near side as Andrews fires near side. That ball was indeed caught on the sideline by Jordan Green. Good teamwork from the officials on this near sideline to spot it and call it, and it's a first down.
Yeah, it was a good catch right there. Initially, I thought it was going to be a run. Oh, yeah, he did get that
foot inbounds.
Might have got both of them inbounds.
This is a really talented wide receiver core that Fort Worth Christian has. First and 10 in Dallas Christian territory. Deep shot.
Ooh.
Just a bit too far for Jacob Trimble and incomplete.
Yeah, this is why I've been advocating for them to pass the ball the whole game. Definitely still mix in a couple runs in there, but he's giving his guys a chance.
For a kid in Trevor Andrews who's 5'9 and 180-something pounds, got a big arm.
Yeah.
Likely the final play of the third quarter here. Anderson, the motion man. They fake it to him, set up the screen near side. That's Bryce Bradley, the H-back, but nothing doing. Well defended by the Dallas Christian defense. And it's going to be third down and long start the fourth quarter.
I don't know who that was who fought off that block right there, but they saved a lot of yards on that play.
We head to the fourth, 35-28, Dallas Christian with the lead, Fort Worth Christian driving and looking for more. We'll be back here in DeSoto.
We are not here to fit into a mold. We are here to celebrate and learn from the unexpected, diverse, and beautiful gente, the fuerte, the strong, the ones risking it all. Para la familia, para la oportunidad, for the lovers of dance, of food, of music. ¡Que viva! We are here to grow together. We are here to thrive, juntos, celebrating our lives every day. La vida.
Our stories are everything. We tell them to help us understand who we are and where we're going from here. That's why we're sharing even more. WFA.
Third down and 9 as we resume play here to start the fourth quarter. Quarterback draw right up the middle. Trevor Andrews lost the football. on the deck is Fort Worth Christian, and I think the Cardinals do recover. They do. Very fortunate is Trevor Andrews that his right tackle Alex Harrelson was Johnny on the spot and recovered it at the 30-yard line, and it's a first down for Fort Worth Christian. What a play diving across by Jackson Berry to strip it out, but the Cardinals recover.
And this second half has been a ride, hasn't it?
This is bonkers. First and 10 at the 30-yard line. Andrews, straight drop. Middle, tipped. Flag flew there on the far side. Kind of in the neighborhood of defensive holding.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking, the same thing. It might be a holding call right there. But I've noticed Dallas Christian is playing a lot more coverage now, so it might open up the run game for Fort Worth Christian.
We've seen Luke Anderson be able to pop a couple. It's a face mask against Dallas Christian. That's a much more important penalty because that's going to bring it all the way down to the 15-yard line. And first and 10 for Trevor Andrews and the Fort Worth Christian Cardinals. Andrews in shotgun. Motion man is Trimble. He'll fake it to him. Looking far side for Bryce Bradley. Somehow he caught that football. That was a millimeter from a pick. Instead, it's six. And Fort Worth Christian, an extra point away from tying it up again.
Yeah, Jaleel Brown read that one perfect. This is the second time tonight he's had a perfect break on a ball and just hasn't been able to come up with it.
What a catch by Bryce Bradley to be secure with the football and bring it in. And Fort Worth Christian, once again with a chance to tie it up. Jackson back out for the extra point. And it's up and through, and we are tied once again, 35 apiece.
What a game. What a game.
Andrews with his fourth total touchdown of the day, three through the air, and the one rushing touchdown there early on in the third quarter. This one goes to Bryce Bradley. And we're tied once again here early in the fourth.
Had a couple fumbles. Interception.
Blocked field goal.
Blocked field goals.
This game's had everything.
Punt return for a touchdown.
360 of you with us right now on the WFAA YouTube channel. Please do us a favor. Share this feed around with your friends and family in the Dallas Christian community, the Fort Worth Christian community. If you just got friends that enjoy good high school football, send them the link because this has turned into a heck of a football game. Another onside kick now, just a little pop-up up the right sideline. Fair catch called for and made at the 34. And back comes Dallas Christian once again in a tie football game, 35 apiece. A 15-yard touchdown hookup from Trevor Andrews to Bryce Bradley. We talked about it earlier tonight. This is a Fort Worth Christian Cardinals team that lost five games in a row to start this season. The fifth and final of those five straight losses against Dallas Christian, at Dallas Christian, 35-25. They were in a bad way, but that game helped them turn things around. Nice play here by Max Makeda. In traffic, still breaking tackles and across midfield. Really nice play from Makeda, who's had a nice night tonight, including that big punt return for a touchdown. But five straight losses from Fort Worth Christian to start this year. They were without their starting quarterback, Trevor Andrews, for a lot of that stretch. That close loss, though, to Dallas Christian, according to their head coach, Nate Sanford, changed everything for this team. Gave them a jolt of confidence, and they've played really good football ever since. 4-2 since that game. 3-1 in district play, and now challenging Jaleel Brown and company once again. But here goes Brown, once again getting to the outside. Brown inside the 25, inside the 20, finally wrangled from behind at the 10-yard line. Jaleel Brown has been the answer every time for Dallas Christian tonight. Anytime Fort Worth Christian does anything, Julius Lewis, Jaleel Brown has been there to have the answer.
Yeah, Dallas Christian somehow comes on top at the end of this game. He deserves the game ball. Started the game off 100 yards in the first quarter, came out this second half and just carried the rock all night.
Well over 200 rushing yards now on the day, in addition to his three touchdowns. Trying to see whether this is updated or not. The most recent update says 228, and that may not be including that big run we just saw right there. He'll get the carry once again, darting his way inside the five and spins his way down to the 2-yard line.
He's slow to get up a little bit, but looks like they're hurrying up, and he's trying to get off the field.
He's going to stay on the field, and Luke Carney's going to pull his way forward into the end zone. He's in. Touchdown. Dallas Christian takes the lead on the QB sneak from the freshman.
What a back-and-forth game. Might come down to who has the ball last.
This has been a fun football game, man. Holzalon for his sixth extra point tonight. Snap is good, hold is down, and the PAT is through, and we are once again in a 7-point football game. ...42-35 the score now. Luke Carney with his first touchdown of the day. First touchdown run of the day. He had the touchdown pass, of course, to Roberts there late in the first quarter that made this a 21-7 lead for Dallas Christian. If you watched the first 18 minutes of this football game and then went away for a while and rejoined us, you'd never believe it was the same game. Never. It was 28-7 Dallas Christian. They were in firm control. They looked, to be frank, like the clearly better team. Credit to Fort Worth Christian, man. They have completely turned this game on its ear. But by the same token, give credit to Dallas Christian because they have continued to answer back every time, and it has been Jaleel Brown, by and large, every time that has led that answer.
Exactly.
So Hosel to kick it away once again. Trimble and Anderson standing at their own 2-yard line. They've let every kick tonight go through the end zone. This time they're going to kick it up short, field it at the 29-yard line, and just lowering his shoulder and picking up a few yards there is Fort Worth Christian's Gus Sanchez.
He was able to look up and see all that room he had to his right. I think he would have been able to make it to the end zone. He had a wall of blockers over there, too, just because of the way the ball was kicked.
Instead, first and 10 at their own 33. I feel like all night long the pressure has been on Trevor Andrews and this Cardinals offense to produce.
It has.
They've always been clawing back and clawing back and clawing back, and to their credit, they've answered each time. But now they have to again. Can they? Anderson with the carry for three. Give him four, perhaps, and a decent start to the series for the Cardinals offense. Tyson King in the comments says he's watching from Beaumont, Texas. Says he's a Cardinal, said he will always be a Charger at heart, though. A bit puzzled by that, but...
ball came out.
That ball came out? Yes, it did, and Dallas Christian's got it. Out of the pile with the football is Jackson Berry, who has had his hands on the ball all night long. Take another look at this. The swing pass to the right side here for Anderson. That ball was punched out from behind. What a play by Max Makeda, who's also had a tremendous night. And Barry comes up with the football, basically the exact opposite of the interception. Barry tipped it, Makeda picked it. This time Makeda with the strip, and Jackson Barry comes up with the football.
Yeah, that's good team football right there, giving your boy an assist. But it was a good job of Makeda by fighting off the block and being able to make the tackle and forcing the fumble.
And just punching it out from behind. And Dallas Christian all of a sudden with a chance to seize back control of this football game. Play action fake, Carney looking near side. Complete in the flat. Gabe Grubbs on the receiving end and a pickup of 6 or 7. Second down and 4. So now Fort Worth Christian's defense that came up in a big spot a couple of times in a 7-point game to keep Dallas Christian off the scoreboard has to do it once again. Jaleel Brown with the handoff, hopping over a tackler in the hole, cutting his way to the outside, breaks another tackle. He's got the first down and then some. Cuts upfield inside the 20. What a run from Jaleel Brown inside the 10-yard line. What a run from the senior who's creeping up on 300 tonight.
Yeah, he's tough to bring down. He showed it all night. Just the ability to stick his foot in the ground, change directions, run so smooth.
Are you kidding me? That was out of control. What a run from Jaleel Brown. The last update for the live stats, 21 carries, 276, and 3 touchdowns. And he'll get the carry again. Brown, this time finally grasping the hold. Did the ball come out there at the end? No, he's still got it. Okay.
I don't know how he stayed up on that, too.
The way he went down, so no, the ball, did the ball come out there at the end? The way he just kind of dives toward the ground, I thought that it had, but if it did, he's between.
Punch it out.
The way that he dove and the way that Gus Sanchez both dove, I thought maybe the ball had come out there at the end of the play. Either way, not much doing, and it's second down and goal from the 9. Carney on play action, flipping it far side. Gabe Grubbs trying to cut up field, breaks a tackle, spun down to the 2-yard line.
A lot of misdirection. It's a good job right there by Jackson Brown, though, fighting off a block.
Clock continues to wind, starting to become a factor here, especially if Dallas Christian can find the end zone. Fort Worth Christian needs a stop here on 3rd and goal. From the 2-yard line, Carney with a straight eye behind him. Now looks sideline for the play from Brian Coghlan. And a timeout called by Mike Wheeler. First timeout called here in the second half by either team. As we welcome you inside the broadcast booth here at DeSoto's Eagle Stadium, gracious host this evening for the second round of the TAPS Division II playoffs. Winner of this game advances, of course, to the state semifinals. Can we get a look at the bracket in TAPS Division II for these two football teams? Dallas Christian, of course, made it to the state championship game a year ago, lost in that state title game against Austin Regents. This year, trying to get back to the title game, and you figure it's probably going to be Austin Regents, the number one team, according to Max Prep's ratings in TAPS Division II this year once again. That will be waiting on the other side of the bracket. If Dallas Christian can get a win here, they'd face the winner of Southwest Christian and Grapevine Faith. Fort Worth Christian, though, has a lot to say about how the final 6 minutes and 57 seconds of this football game go, Julius. They need a stop, though, here on 3rd down and goal from the 2.
Yeah, they need to keep them out of the end zone, hold them to a field goal. If not, 14-point deficit in the last 7 minutes. It's not looking good for Fort Worth Christian.
Back out of the timeout, it'll be Carney under center. Straight eye behind him. Grubbs the fullback, and Jaleel Brown creeping up on 300 yards tonight. Dots the eye. He'll get the toss, run a near side, give him 300 on the nose and four touchdowns tonight for Jaleel Brown.
Yeah, everybody thinks the ball's going up the middle. The defense was lined up. Dallas Christian realized they had the edge. They just swung, did the sweep. So that's four for him tonight.
He had 299 yards prior to that one-yard touchdown. Jaleel Brown now 24 carries, 300 yards, and four touchdowns, and he stakes Dallas Christian to a two-touchdown lead. Hosel on for his seventh extra point of the day, and it's up and through, and it's a 49-35 lead for Dallas Christian with 6:53 to play in the fourth.
Looks like spotting them those two touchdowns early in the first quarter is coming back to haunt Fort Worth Christian right now.
Just as we saw happen between these two teams when they played back on October 1st, Dallas Christian jumped out to a 14-0 lead in both meetings of these two teams this season. On October 1st, absent those 14 points, Fort Worth Christian would have won the game. They outscored them by four. Now I'm struggling with math. That game was a 10-point final margin. So, yes, Fort Worth Christian outscored them by four the rest of the way. Tonight, those 14 points are the difference in the football game. 49-35, Dallas Christian with the lead, with now under 7 minutes to play here in the fourth quarter. So if you're Trevor Andrews in this Fort Worth Christian offense, Julius, what do you have to do now to find the answer?
Do what you've done on every scoring drive you have. Misdirection, throw the ball deep, get the ball out to your playmakers, and just protect the football.
This is interesting. A comment here on YouTube from Wes Tollison saying that Austin Regions has lost tonight. So there will be a new champ in Taps Division II this year. I did not expect to see that note this evening. See if I can independently confirm that, but that would be a rather substantial development in Taps Division II. Austin Regions was taking on Second Baptist tonight. I'll keep an eye out for a score here. I haven't found anything just yet. But at least according to the comment there from Wes Tollison, Second Baptist got the win tonight. Back comes Andrews, quick throw near side, Trimble fell down. I beg your pardon, it's Jordan Green, the intended receiver. Lost his footing and it's second and 10.
I like how they came out on this drive in 10 personnel.
Quick throw far side, complete in the arms of Gus Sanchez.
I think we should, next year when we do this, we should quiz the YouTube chat. We probably do it right now. Who in the YouTube chat
knows what 10 personnel means?
Yeah.
Explain that for those that don't understand how that terminology works.
Okay, I will after this play.
Trevor Andrews on the quarterback draw. He'll have the first down. Key play there on third down and short. Out to the 44-yard line, and a fresh set of downs here for the Cardinals. Clock continues to wind now as they reset the sticks, 6:15 and moving.
So you have 10 personnel, you have 20 personnel, 11 personnel, 12 personnel. The first number, so the 1 and 10, that's how many running backs are on the field.
Quick throw far side, Jacob Trimble with a head of steam into Dallas Christian territory and down to the 34-yard line.
Yep. So if it was 12 personnel, there'd be one running back on the field, and the 2 and 12 would be tight ends. Mm-hmm. So
when you say it's 10 personnel, you're talking about coming out without a tight end and with only one back on the field,
yep.
A wide open set to try and push the football down the field in the passing game.
Yes, sir.
First and 10 at the 34 as they continue to try to push the football down the field in the passing game. Throw near side, complete for Jordan Green, but bottled up there by Trip Roberts. And it will go down as only a gain of one. I don't have a final score yet from Second Baptist, but I am seeing that they led that game 20-10 in the fourth quarter. So it certainly seems more than plausible that Austin Regents did fall tonight. Near side, right through the hands of Carter Marlowe, and incomplete.
Yeah, he took his eyes downfield before he caught the ball. He knew he had a lot of room in front of him to run. Sense of urgency for Fort Worth. Christian's got to start picking up here soon.
Third down and nine. 5:12 to play in the fourth in a two-touchdown game. Far side, complete, Trimble, first down inside the 20, and spun down to the 15.
Good route right there. 10-yard out.
Andrews, right side. Out of bounds. Make sure to join us tonight on the WFA News at 10. We're about 10 minutes away from joining the WFA News at 10. Live in progress, high school game night. Joe Trahan out at the Duncanville Mesquite game. Jonah Javad at Globe Life Field tonight with the cushy assignment, watching Allen and Lake Highlands. Highlights of both of those games, and we'll dip in live, I assume anyway, into this game in just a few minutes' time. That was a broken play, and Andrews had nowhere to go, and he loses a chunk of yards. I think he expected the back to take the football. Either that or he just realized he made the wrong read, perhaps.
Yeah, a little bit of both. Somebody wasn't on the same page. Different books, actually. But clock's running right now. Get something going.
Third down and 14. They've got to get to the 5-yard stripe for a first down. Andrews scanning, pressure in his face again. Looking downfield and just runs out of bounds. Should have just thrown the football away. Lost a big chunk of yards there and didn't need to. Well outside the pocket there. Just throw that football away and save yourself 10 or 12 yards.
I think he might have had a mental lapse right there. Last two plays have not been good for him.
So that sets up fourth down and 24. They feel like their quarterback, Jackson Beck, only has range out to about 40, which is good range for a high school kicker, but
no need to kick you now. Yeah.
One, not in range. Two, no good. A field goal does you no good right now. So on fourth and 24, it's intercepted. Grubbs cuts across it and makes the interception, and Gabe Grubbs has a ton of running room. Inside the 50-yard line, cuts back inside the 40, and finally wrangled down by the quarterback, Andrews. Inside the 35-yard line, Gabe Grubbs makes the play that might just finish this football game.
Yeah, Andrews had the right guy, but he was just a little late over the middle. And when you're late over the middle and you have two high safeties, not a recipe, kind of a recipe for disaster. Good job right there by Grubbs.
So in a two-score game, Gabe Grubbs makes the interception on fourth and a mile. And now Dallas Christian with an opportunity to try and salt away some of this 353. Timeout called by Dallas Christian.
This game has been a good one.
We have gotten ourselves a show tonight between Dallas Christian and Fort Worth Christian, trying to decide who's got the better. Who's better?
Yeah.
Fort Worth or Dallas? Where do you fall on that, TCU man?
I don't think this game really encompasses the whole rivalry between Fort Worth and Dallas. Some teams get luckier than other teams early on in the games, but I forgot what the question you asked me was already, so who knows?
I mean, you went to TCU. I got to imagine you side with Fort Worth over Dallas.
I was siding with Fort Worth on this one.
You went to Mansfield.
Directly in the middle of Fort Worth and Dallas, almost.
But technically in Tarrant County, no?
Yeah.
So I think, you know, that's another potential tiebreaker that
yep.
goes in Fort Worth's bin for you. I have never lived in Fort Worth. I did live in Dallas when I first moved to the DFW area. Lived there for, the first 3 years that I was living and working here in DFW. I've since moved down to Ellis County with my wife, who was in Waco for a while. We needed kind of a little midway point.
Ugh.
So, Waxahachie has become home. We decided we wanted to spend a whole lot of time hanging out with Dale Hansen.
Yeah.
Out of the timeout here, Dallas Christian with a 2-touchdown lead and looking to put this one away. Hall nearly lost there by Carney on the snap. Tosses it to Jaleel Brown, and he's able to maybe gain a yard. Did stay in bounds, so the clock will continue to run here. Timeout called by Fort Worth Christian. They have two remaining now after that timeout was called. So they're going to do all they can, of course, to try and get the football back as quickly as possible and give their offense a chance to make something, Julius, of these final 2 minutes and 56 seconds.
Yeah.
It all kind of went south on them, though, on that previous possession.
It did, right there at the really last three plays. Miscommunication on the read option. Running out of bounds instead of throwing it away and then throwing late over the middle.
Two 1 yard touchdown runs, one from Luke Carney, one from Jaleel Brown. The scores that have set the margin here in the fourth quarter. It was 35 all, 38 seconds into the final period. As Trevor Andrews hit Bryce Bradley to tie it up at 35 points apiece. But now Jaleel Brown looking to salt this one away, trying to break to the outside, cuts up field inside the 25, and taken down there. And you imagine Fort Worth Christian will use another timeout. They haven't yet.
Very surprising.
It is fourth down here forthcoming for Dallas Christian. And with 26 still on the play clock.
I guess you want to save those two timeouts for your offensive possession.
I guess. But, I mean, those 30 seconds, you can do a better job of saving time when you're on the offensive side. You have better control over that when you have possession of the football. Right now, Dallas Christian's going to let this wind all the way down, and they will go for it here on fourth down and three, trying to end the football game right here. Jaleel Brown on the toss, trying to get to the outside. Brown's got the first down and then some. Inside the 10, give Jaleel Brown 5 touchdowns on the day. What a night for the senior running back, and that one will put this game to bed.
Yeah, I agree with you. I think that Fort Worth Christian should have probably called that timeout. They might have gotten to the heads of the Could have potentially gotten to the heads of the coaches on the Dallas Christian side, talked them out of going for it.
I don't think so. I think if you got Jaleel Brown and you're Mike Wheeler and you're the offensive coordinator, Brian Coghlan, give the ball to number one. 2 minutes even on the clock here in the fourth and the fifth. Touchdown run of the day from Jaleel Brown makes it 56-35. And that will put this game in the books. Still waiting for the stats to fully update. They still don't show his fifth touchdown run just yet. Through 4 touchdown runs, he was at 27 for 304. Again, we hope you'll join us tonight on high school game night here in just a couple minutes. Joe Trahan out at the Duncanville Mesquite game. Jonah Javad at the Allen Lake Highlands game. Highlights of both of those games. And we'll dip in live here as we get closer to the holidays here on Friday Night Football. A 25-yard touchdown run there from Jaleel Brown. to make it 56-35. Stats have updated now. 29 carries, 334 yards, and 5 touchdowns for Jaleel Brown. A virtuoso performance from the senior running back. Now Fort Worth Christian getting desperate right off the jump as Trimble tried to fire it across the field to Luke Anderson. That could have been a lot of fun. Didn't work out for him. And out comes Trevor Andrews and company once again.
It was creative.
I mean, listen, down 3 scores with this little time left, you got to do everything you can to take advantage of every time you get the football in your hands. Give Fort Worth Christian credit, man. They fought back from a 3-score deficit earlier in this football game. Tied this game up at 28 points apiece. Tied it again at 35. They're going to go trick play once again here. Trimble trying to look downfield into a lot of traffic, and it's picked off. Makeda with his second pick of the day, and he's got a convoy. Makeda's going to put this one way out of reach. The pick six for the senior Makeda.
This was definitely out of reach. But the trick play didn't really go as well as I thought it was. A lot of standing around, a lot of miscommunication. Just threw it up there.
I mean, you understand certainly what Fort Worth Christian is trying to do. They got to make something happen, and they got to make it happen fast. Down 3 scores, but it goes the other direction, and now they're down 4. Max Makeda with the pick six. It's really unfortunate because this is going to look like a blowout, and it just wasn't.
Yeah.
This game was 35 all early on in this fourth quarter. But the Max Makeda pick six, I think, will be the final salvo in this game. Yeah. The way that it's been kind of tacked on here late, who knows, but
fourth quarter started out 35-35, and then almost 30 points later.
4 straight touchdowns from Dallas Christian. The last 2 separated by just 20 seconds as Max Makeda has the pick six following Jaleel Brown's 25-yard touchdown run. Again, we will join high school game night live in progress here in a matter of moments. In what has all of a sudden become a 63-35 Dallas Christian lead.
I think this is a bold statement win for Dallas Christian, though.
And I was able to confirm just a couple minutes ago that Austin Regions did indeed fall tonight 26-16 against Second Baptist. So Taps D2 is wide open. Back comes Trevor Andrews in the offense. As we welcome in our WFAA television audience, Joe, thanks so much. A 63-35 score right now with a 1:38 to play here in the fourth. Believe it or not, this was a 35-35 football game just about a minute into this fourth quarter. Fort Worth Christian fought real hard in this one, but Dallas Christian has poured it on late. Luke Carney with a 1-yard touchdown run here with 10:22 to play in the fourth gave Dallas Christian the lead for good, and Jaleel Brown, who has had a tremendous night tonight, over 300 rushing yards and 5 touchdowns, made it 49-35. A couple of garbage time scores here from Dallas Christian has spread this one out, and they are prepared to move on to the state semifinals in Taps Division II. 63-35 the score right now. Fort Worth Christian back with the football and trying to make something of this final 91 seconds, but a valiant effort that has gone awry for Fort Worth Christian. Dallas Christian set to move on. Joe, we'll pass it back to you. Passing complete there for Andrews, buck 27 here in the fourth. And Julius, it's kind of amazing how quickly this game did go sideways for Fort Worth Christian, because they were in such an interesting football game for a lot of this second half, did a great job to come back and really make this a compelling game all through the third quarter and into the fourth. But a late push here from Dallas Christian has obviously turned this into a much wider margin than the game really ever was, realistically.
Yeah, definitely. The game started off sideways for Fort Worth Christian. They got back right. Second quarter, third quarter. Beginning of the fourth quarter, we thought it was going to be a little bit closer than what it was right now, but credit to Dallas Christian for what they did.
And I say it again, Dallas Christian, they've got everything in front of them now. Moving on to the state semifinals. Perhaps after this fourth down play, we can pull that TAPS Division II bracket up one more time. But first, fourth down and nine here for Trevor Andrews and company, trying to keep their slim hopes alive. Throws it far side, off the hands of Jacob Trimble. And that'll be the final offensive snap tonight, you would imagine, for Fort Worth Christian. There's a look at your TAPS Division II bracket. Southwest Christian and Grapevine Faith on the other side of the bracket. Let me see if I can get a score in that game. But Dallas Christian will take on the winner of that football game in the state semifinals. And then Second Baptist knocking off Austin Regents on the other side of the bracket. So TAPS Division II wide open, as what was statistically anyway the top team in TAPS Division II coming into this postseason was knocked off tonight. Looking for a Grapevine Faith score if I can find one. Looks like Southwest Christian got the win. That went final just about a half an hour ago. Southwest Christian with a 28-22 win over Grapevine Faith. So it's going to be Dallas Christian and Southwest Christian in the state semifinals in TAPS Division II. Luke Carney, the freshman quarterback, with a kneel down here. A couple more of those, and you can put this one to bed.
Southwest Christian actually beat Fort Worth Christian 36-7 earlier this year.
That was back on October the 22nd, and by that point, Fort Worth Christian had started to kind of turn their season around. They were playing a lot better football at that point. So Southwest Christian, certainly a talented team. Interesting matchup in the state semifinals next week on this side of the bracket in TAPS D2. One final kneel down, and Dallas Christian can move on. Luke Carney with the kneel down, and the Chargers with a dominant fourth quarter. 28 unanswered, and a 63-35 win. Moving on to the state semifinals. And that young man right there, Jaleel Brown, with a sensational day. 29 carries, 334 yards, and 5 touchdowns. A dominant performance from Jaleel Brown, the senior running back for Dallas Christian. Julius, you can't say enough good things about what this young man did today.
Yeah, you can't. 5 touchdowns, very impressive. 300-plus yards, very impressive. Just an impressive night overall for him.
We do hope this is not the final Friday Night Football broadcast of the year. We will not have a broadcast next week for the Thanksgiving holiday, but we hope to be back with you in early December with UIL playoff games. That is still TBD. We will get back with you as soon as we've got more information and a matchup to promote as we get into the opening couple of days of December. So keep an eye out for that. We hope we'll have more high school football action for you here on Friday Night Football over the balance of this season. But tonight, What a performance from Dallas Christian. A big early lead thanks to Jaleel Brown, and a tremendous finishing kick thanks to Jaleel Brown and the Dallas Christian defense. Max Makeda with the pick six, the strip by Makeda that was recovered by Dallas Christian's Jackson Berry. The defense made some key plays when they needed to shut down Fort Worth Christian, and Jaleel Brown paid it all off. 29 for 334 and 5 touchdowns in a 63-35 win for Dallas Christian, and the Chargers are on to the state semifinals. For our entire Friday Night Football crew, director Clay Marshall, photographers Dwayne Watkins and Raul Garcia, digital coordinators Nick Blackhall and Alex Cruz back in-house, Julius Lewis alongside, I'm Mike Leslie. So long from DeSoto, where the final score one final time is 63-35. Dallas Christian moving on to the state semis. All our Friday Night Football broadcasts stream live and are archived in perpetuity on the WFAA YouTube channel. This has been a presentation of WFAA-TV.